It's the best of Ron and Fez on XM 202.
You are as red as a fucking apple today.
Yeah.
What is going on?
I got the worst case of windburn. Usually I take a taxi to...
What'd you do today? Ride on the outside of the train?
I usually
The reason why you look like that is from windburn?
Yeah. It's God's just deciding to just screw
me over.
You
sure it's not an internal thing?
Is it your medicine?
It could be
you
the
medicine. You say your medicine makes you piss orange. Why do you, when you come in for a second, are the interns bringing you Coke?
I have no idea what that was about.
Who are you?
I
mean,
I have no idea what that was about.
Were they trying to guess what you want?
I don't know.
I'm sorry. Before we go to Perfect Strangers, you said his medicine makes him piss orange?
Yeah.
Are you the one staining the bathroom then?
Yes. I'm sorry, Fez, but I am.
The far urinal, I look like someone poured dye in it.
Yeah.
There is orange, bright orange stains all over the urinal, all over the floor.
I know. And
if that's you, you're not making it into the urinal.
I know. I'm going into the stall from now on. But the problem is my
piss... What are you doing, piss and sulfur?
It's not coming out stream-like. Mm-hmm. It's just like a fucking
spray?
Sprinkle. Like, remember...
Light spray?
Remember that, like, sprinkle thing that people would put on their front lawn?
Do I?
But that's the way it's coming out. So I can't control that.
Like this?
Yeah.
You go back and forth as you do it?
So I'm not going to be doing...
Let the kids run back.
I'm just going to use the far left stall from now on, so don't go in that. But anyway, Perfect Strangers was... That was one of the best.
I
got to
see some of the piss stains.
Oh, they're in there.
I'm so curious now.
Do you want me to give you I'll go in a cup and give you a sample of what my piss looks like.
Yeah.
All right. I'll do that in private.
But have a clear cup. I'm not going to look in one of these. I've got to see. I got to see it from the other side.
Okay.
Yeah. Just piss in your hand and run back in with it. What is wrong with him? This new girl of his, Fezzi, she's too much.
It is.
She's too much for him to handle.
Because his health is falling apart in front of our eyes.
But, you know, I know you love her and you want to get married, but you're pissing orange. We can't have that. It's too much.
The bathroom is stained from him missing.
What are you doing, staring and looking around in the urinal?
No, because that's the urinal that I go to if
you
I
have
to
your
go.
Special urinal?
I go to the one as far away from the door as possible, up against the wall.
Yeah.
So if
the
I...
The one with the camera. The Pal Talk pisser.
That has a camera?
Yeah, it does.
Great. But I go to that one, and then I saw this orange shit all over it.
Shit?
It's that thick. Those stains are that thick, and I'm like... All right, I don't know what's been in here, and I can't use this urinal now.
Is it stained, like, for good?
It looks like it, yeah. It's a big, thick stain.
Earl, send somebody in to check the piss tank. I don't even believe the story.
Like someone poured varnish.
Earl, during all your problems, your bleed-outs, you ever piss orange?
Never. Never, never, never. I crapped blood, but that's about it. But that only lasted a few days.
Sorry to hear that. Sorry it only lasted a few days. I was trying to get you on the Today Show.
He sounds like he misses it.
Yeah, he does.
No, I don't. Oh, yeah. God, no.
It was only
a
few days. A few days of glory.
Just sitting on a bolt and your head spinning because you just lose whatever equilibrium you have.
Don't bring it all the way over here. That is unbelievably dark.
That is Tang.
Yeah.
He is pissing Tang.
It's very... Very upsetting to me to see it, and when it goes all over the
white...
You
know what? It's almost golden.
He warned me that this would happen, and he said...
I'm warning you, if you don't slow down, mister, you're going to be pissing bright orange.
He said there is going to be a lot of side effects.
Like what else?
Yeah, I think he did mention something about my complexion. Like, it's just going to...
Your complexion is the same as that piss, which you blamed on windburn. How did you get here today that you thought you got windburn?
It was quite windy in Astoria, Queens. And
what did you do, walk all the way?
Usually
to
I
work?
Take a cab to the subway.
You're fucking kidding me. How far do I've never even heard of a ham and egg like
this.
How far away is that?
It's like 15-minute walk, and I figure...
You live 15 minutes from the train that you have to catch
right. To
come here.
Yes.
Where do you live? Mexico?
No, it's just that's where it is. So a lot of times we'll take a cab, but today I walked and he also said don't go out in the sunlight. So because I walked, wind and sunlight, I'm in big trouble. This is on top of my regular sensitivity.
If that's from Windburn, you must have come here today by kite.
I don't feel good about myself, that's
no
for sure.
No one travels by kite. Let's be honest.
No one?
No one.
James and the Giant Peach. I think he traveled by kite, maybe.
I don't. Oh. Not familiar with him. I'm an adult. You act like you're going to drink it, but you won't. Look how much the fucker wants to drink. Look at his face. He's dying, though. It's almost like an urge that you have
25,
to do it.
25 bucks?
25 bucks.
He's dying to be dared.
The whole thing?
I'll do the best I can.
No.
The best I can.
No, is that even something dangerous because it's not nice, clean urine?
Oh, I didn't even think about that. Well, it's filled with
even the nice clean makes me wonder.
Well, remember we had the guy, some kind of fucking yogi or whatever, came on the show and drank his own piss? Right?
Oh, yeah.
He comes in, he thought it was a thing. He tried to drink his own piss. Then Paulo pissed in a cup and drank it with ice. And he's going like, this is really not bad. So sick.
On the rocks.
There it is. No, don't do it.
Come on.
Why are you dying to drink your own piss? Seriously.
I need the scratch.
You need 25?
Taxes took the fuck out of me. I don't know what's going on with America. They're allowed to do that?
Hey, you want to get mad? Try and guess how much I got back. You'll be fucking furious. Yeah. I don't know what my accountant did, but this was like every year I've ever had put together in one. And I actually called them back up, and I go, if I'm going to get fucking, you know, this is great, but I don't want to get arrested for it.
Right. He's good.
I don't know. Either that or we're in a dangerous situation.
Let me put it this way. So far, he's so good.
Don't do it. Don't. Well, Dave,
let me
take
just
it away.
Look at it.
Huh?
Let me just sniff her out.
But what is the urge? Because I saw you look at it.
It looks delicious.
Smile, and you had a look like you wanted me to bet you to do
I'll
it.
I'll be honest with you.
You know what I mean? Like, is this what you're thinking? And I'm not.
No.
I'm going to be totally honest. I'm
no, I know. But
it does look like Kool-Aid.
Yeah, I mean, it does look kind of good.
What Kool-Aid comes. Don't do it, Dave. Just the smell itself?
Yeah.
Just smell it and see what it's like.
No.
Now you're ready to go. Why are you looking like you want to? No one is daring you.
I thought you said $25.
You said that.
Oh.
I just found out I'm fucking into this reef thing. I'm a little upset about that. Something else we were supposed to do, too. Something along those lines.
Let's see.
Oh, here's a good story. So, yesterday... we said we were going to take Pitsy out for his dinner. And we were going to go to Ben Benson's because HTG, you somehow got money out of her for your stupid birthday.
Out of the kindness of her heart, she gave me $250 in gift certificates to Ben Benson's.
I'm going to tell you something right now. Before you ever got $250 out of me, I'd be dead. My house would be burned down. That would be a firefight. And I've known you forever. And it would be a firefight for an ashtray given fuck like you to get even a dime off me.
I gave a more sentimental gift. A Toot Shore ashtray.
By the way, I noticed it's almost hanging out the window where the kids sit and smoke.
Oh, I know.
It's a quarter of an inch away from the window. So we're like, today, all right, you make this big pronouncement. I'm in the mood for steak. Why don't we go to Ben Benson's? Well, Sal called us, but I didn't get to his call.
Sound from AJ Maxwell's.
Yes, please don't interrupt me when you see me about to say the name of his restaurant. So, Sal from AJ Maxwell's, I didn't get a chance to him. So, at the show ends, we're sitting in here yesterday. Keith the cop comes in. Why would you guys insult Sal? And we go, how do we insult him? You're going to Ben Benson's? Ronnie, this can't happen. This cannot happen. Well, what are you talking about? You won't come to eat at his place. Now he's got to hear you're going to Ben Benson's? No, let's just forget about it. You're going to Sal's. Sal wants to see you at AJ Maxwell's. You need to be at AJ Maxwell's. You're ruining this for everybody. So apparently there was hard feelings over us going to Ben Benson's today.
Well, see, it was not a slight at Sal at AJ Maxwell's.
Why would you pick another steakhouse and not his?
Because I had gift certificates and I thought that would be a nice way to use them.
I was doing my Keith impression.
Oh.
Why are you doing this? Why are you trying to ruin him?
So, yeah, that was very hurt feelings. I don't want to... After Eastside Dave and his fiance went in there and tried to bankrupt Sal and AJ Maxwell's, I feel a little self-conscious about walking in the place.
$450 their bill came to.
Yeah, but that's...
Two different $150 bottles worth of wine.
He put the bottles in front of us. I didn't know that they were going to cost that much.
Why'd you have to have two?
We were drinking. I mean, it was
festive.
There's
two of them. They each had a bottle in front of them.
And
Barfly.
He should. He just put
the bottle
of wine.
Seriously, you're Mickey Rourke and Barfly right now.
I don't aspire to be, but he puts a nice bottle of wine. We liked it so much. I think that shows how much we enjoyed it.
You demand it more.
That's right.
So, yeah. Just...
Then they said you guys left a tip $4.50.
No, they didn't say that.
You dropped a 1% tip.
That was a confusing night all around. I just want to sip outside.
Don't
here.
Do it. Sis, don't. Not yet. Not yet. Oh, God, there he goes. No, you almost threw up. The smell itself.
The smell getting to you?
So disgusting.
Oh, my.
Hold on. Wait. We need witnesses. Make sure the O&A guys come in. Dave's trying to drink his own piss.
God. Now you promised to give me $25?
I'll put
You got $450.
No, bullshit. Bullshit. Wait, here's what I would do. For $25, I'll put in your part of the tip for lunch today.
$25.
$25. Here's this pistol. First of all, guys, look how orange, almost copper or golden it is. From the, what kind of medicine? Just antibiotics?
No, it's in my bag.
Is it antibiotics?
Dick medicine, yes.
But it's nothing that would be bad for you to drink because it's already in your body, right?
I would think it would be filled with vitamins.
Well, just smell it right now. You would think. How bad is it? Fez, give it a smell.
Here.
Wait.
Oh my God.
Here. Wait. Fez,
I'll
give it a smell. I want Fez to give it a smell.
Let me smell
because
it
I
first.
Gotta know.
I gotta get up.
Huh? I don't know how bad
it is. Let Fez have a smell.
Sorry.
Take a big whiff, too, Fezzy, not a sissy whiff.
Oh, my God.
What's it smell like?
It's like someone pissed on really smelly shoes. It's like rotten fruit or something. Like if you had a bushel of peaches that went bad in a basement somewhere.
All right, here he goes.
It's such a fertile smell.
Are you sure there's something you want to do, Dave?
$25?
Oh. Yeah. To drink your own bad pee? Look, he's almost...
Yeah, I need a much bigger bucket.
Hey, if you spit, you're fucking getting an 8.
Oh, that...
8.
If I spit, I
25
get...
25 means, you know, kill it.
I lose $17 for
yeah.
That.
There he goes.
Where's he going? What happened? It went in his mouth. I know that much.
Oh. I'm almost losing it. Oh. I'm ready to throw it myself.
Oh, that's so gross.
No.
What was it like, Dave? Was it good?
Oh, my God. Poison tasted better when I drank it accidentally. I was 5.
What?
Poison accidentally when I was 5.
Accidentally? Or because your mom gave it to you with your own
A little bit of both.
Oh, that was in an apple. Your stepmom was trying to get rid of you.
I've never done this before. I almost threw up, man. My eyes are actually starting to water. That was hideous. All right, you get $8 for that. For not fucking.
$8?
You didn't swallow.
You spit it out once it was in your mouth, once you swished it around.
Now I know. Now I know you're sick.
Like it was
now
a wine tasting.
Ew! I just spit accidentally and it came out orange. So it's still in my teeth and tongue.
That was like a Uncle Milty spit take that he did right before he started woofing.
I think that's called a piss take, not a spit take. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, is that disgusting? And instantaneous.
Yeah.
The
second the piss went in his mouth, he started puking. And it's sprayed all up, and of course,
yeah.
Well, who's left to clean it up? A lowly intern.
Not anymore.
Oh yeah, he's associate producer.
He got hired.
Yeah. Oh, he did
to clean up piss.
Yeah. Why the fuck don't you delegate that responsibility to a lowly intern?
Because that's Lily's the only one left, and we all be sued.
You can't have a nice young.
And then I had to clean up his piss.
Is there any other business where interns have to do shit they have to do in radio? It's never at like Mafia, IBM.
Yeah, Mafia interns you know? Have it easier.
I'm interning over there at
Lehman Brothers. I was cleaning up piss vomit today. We had a down day. The market was really down. And
yeah, what are you getting, some dentine for yourself?
I need some. I know it's improper to chew gum on the radio, Mr. B, but I got fucking piss mouth.
I would not.
It's not improper to drink piss, but chewing gum, wow, you're offending.
That's yeah, you really, seriously. Look. We've crossed the line.
He's pointing and laughing to his piss how much, drops all right, that are on the
console. If you give me a straw, how much if I snort the piss on the desk?
I'll throw an extra $3.
Give me a straw!
See, here's the thing. Damn. He pisses to show us how deeply orange his piss is now. And then he starts to go like this. Like I'm daring him when I wasn't. He's like, I know what you're thinking.
So he holds it up so you make him for money.
He's right.
I need the money.
All right, $8, you got it.
If you had swallowed it, you would have gotten 25.
All right. I'm going to snort some piss now.
Oh, God. Damn, I got to get away from it.
How is it?
He's on the floor.
And here's the thing. That'll be dripping an hour and a half from now. What?
$3.
Yes. You're up to 11. All right, do me a favor. Wipe your piss slobber off, you disgusting bastard.
He's
so hanging.
He's so gross. He's got drool, spit, and everything hanging off of him.
It's why like does a St. Bernard with piss coming out of its mouth.
Turner and
what is wrong with... What is wrong? Keep his
pie. Right, now Pitsy's throwing up.
Why are you running away with the paper towels? I desperately need those.
Great. It's a total barfarama.
I swear to God, I almost threw up myself. That was so close. And yeah, it was one of the more exciting moments I've ever experienced.
I need to see a piss ears, note, and nose.
You're joking.
Ears, what?
Note, first of all, they think that... The problems with his dick is from fucking jelly, that he might have gotten some jelly up in there anyway.
Maybe. Yeah.
From fucking jelly?
Yeah.
Or fucking jelly?
No, fucking jelly, putting himself over the top of a thing of jelly.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought that like a lubricant kind of jelly.
No.
No, grape Welch's.
Oh, I should have known.
What goes good with peanut
why
butter?
Would I think it would be some kind of jelly lubricant that you use during normal sex or something? Of course, fucking jelly.
Yeah, I think they got a little bit of the grape got in there.
Went in there.
You've seen the Welch's commercials. It's great for fucking too, Mom.
Listen, if you microwave it, it is the next closest thing to pussy.
Now,
trust me.
Here's the good news: your new father-in-law Doug has been listening to the show.
I don't want that,
so
Mr. Doug.
He's heard you snort piss, drink piss, and then talk about microwaving jelly and banging it.
Sir, I promise I'm done with those things after today.
You know what, though? This shows, because he did it for money, that he'll be a good provider.
Right.
Yeah.
He'll make sure the rent is paid, the bills are paid, no matter what it takes.
Sure, that's how Donald Trump got his start. Just drinking piss and snorting it and begging people to give him dollars.
That's what he'll do when the landlord comes looking for the rent. Can I just drink my piss?
How much?
A week? Can I stay another week if I drink my piss?
I just got her $11.
It's not a barter system that we live in. This was the ancient Greeks. We're constantly drinking their own piss.
Oh, man.
You all right?
I'm feeling a little funny from that now.
You know what it might be from drinking piss? That's probably what got to you.
Yeah. Starting to feel a little heated.
Yeah.
Maybe there was something in those antibiotics.
Antibiotics.
That wasn't good for me.
Yeah, is that what makes it so golden yellow?
Yeah, that is what happened. The doctor said that.
Because I've been hearing the whole story of your piss problems and dick problems, and I feel for you.
Thank you. It's very painful. I mean, it really changes your life.
Well, the doctor did say it came from fucking at an adult level, the first time in his life.
I ain't saying that graphic of a manner.
Well, what did he say? You had honeymoon what?
Cystitis.
Is that the name of it?
That's what the guy said in the email. Yeah. The doctor said prostatitis with urethritis mixture. My ass and my
a lot of itises.
Cock.
Yeah. Your ass and your cock?
Yeah.
Now your throat's starting to close.
Isn't a cystitis like a cyst? Isn't that a mass? Some kind of a
I didn't ask a lot of questions.
No, why do that with a doctor?
Yesterday, this is what a goer this kid is, though. They stick some kind of swab in his cock.
Ugh.
He passes out, and then they wake him up, and he comes to work.
I'd be taking a month off.
He was sweating. He comes in sweating like an animal. I'm going to do my best, but I don't know if I can keep it together. They just brought me through. And then he said, the way when he wakes up, the doctor and the nurse have towels, and they're just like he got knocked out in 1908.
And the pants are still down.
She had some flimsy yellow folder. I'm like, it's not even a fucking fan. It's a folder.
You don't have doctor fans that they wave on. You're not supposed to pass out like that.
They should tell me when they're going to put the pipe in my cock. It was that doctor
it's
was
only polite.
He's a very impulsive man, Dr. Kaufman.
I didn't do it impulsively. This is the procedure.
He didn't tell me he was going to do it that swift.
Would you have let him?
I don't know. I need to prepare myself.
I'd have fucking dove through a window like the cowardly lion and been running out of there.
Right?
It would have, yeah, no it would happen. Yeah. Fuck it. I'd rather it rots and falls off before I let you stick anything in my dick hole.
Well, that was the third time in 5 days, so there's going to be no more pipes in it for quite a while.
There is no getting ready for that. That is just the old Band-Aid trick. I'll do it on three. One, two, and rip.
Yeah.
You just, all right, tell me when you're ready. Wham!
I'd rather be shot in the cock than have someone take the time to go up there like that with a fucking wire.
Yeah. Oh, this was more of a pipe.
What do you mean pipe?
Like it was like a small
PVC
thin pipe because he needed to put it in hard and look around. So actually, not only did he put it in, he spread it around.
Okay. All right, no. Yeah, see, all the guys grabbed themselves.
Can't help it.
You can't.
I almost went down.
Reaction.
Almost fucking went down.
You're
like
looking
it
a little peeking.
Yeah. I need some piss to bring me back into things.
How did you get three diagnoses for
Yeah, I mean, I don't know what they're doing. I went to Friday, and then I
heard that's the problem. You went to Fridays instead of a doctor.
Put a chicken wing up his dick
hole. Don't do that. Don't go to Fridays for your medical treatment.
No more. I'm sticking with Dr. Kaufman. Even if he does do things without my notification, like his finger in my ass. And
you probably went to Charlie Kaufman. You're just in some bizarre movie. There's nothing you need to figure out by putting a pipe in my cock. That's not something. That's something I would go to the doctor for, but not to have after I got there.
No.
Yeah.
A pipe. I remember as a kid jacking it with soap.
Yeah.
Which you learn very early on, don't do.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because on the downstroke.
Yeah.
It pulls the skin back a little. And the tip opens up a little.
Yep. Yeah.
And then the soap will build up around your hand. And if a little bit gets in there, you're crying on the floor of your shower like a rape scene.
Right.
Yeah. And that enough is pain. But to get a pipe shoved in your dick hole, sorry.
It was worse. Right, yeah. It was worse than this. Oh.
Did you ever get fucking involved in this? Like when you're younger and you think, yeah, well, fuck with champagne. I fucking pour champagne on this broad. She fucking starts freaking out like I hit her with acid. She's screaming and trying to get out of it. I'm like, hey, I still got this fucking problem we got to take care of.
That's another thing. The things that look or sound romantic.
I know. We're like,
and it's nothing. Fucking in a pool is another thing that just you don't do.
Yeah.
Chlorinated water is amongst the worst lubricant ever.
Yeah.
You get like, it's like rub the rubber of an inner tube with your hand, and that kind of skipping thing is what happens.
But it is fun when you pull out, and then it looks like you've created a jellyfish. It just fucking floats around.
The hot tub looks like it drops soup.
Yeah. I know. As far as getting in anyone else's hot tub, fuck that.
No.
That's ridiculous.
You know the first time someone gets a hot tub, they drink and go, let's fuck in the hot tub.
Right.
So now when guests come over, what are
They're
you doing?
Like animals. Oh, by the way, I just came on you.
I wish I could experience that, though. I mean,
yeah.
Oh, you're drinking your own piss. You're on your way. Things are starting to happen for you. I see it.
I like to spank it in the bathtub sometimes, but like Mr. Anthony says, I won't use shampoo or soap or anything.
But the bathtub isn't draining. You're jelly. The bathtub isn't draining all the time. I could see jacking it in the shower or something, but in the bathtub, you lay in it.
Yeah, it feels real good.
Shampoo
water. It's so warm.
Oh, what a psycho. Yeah. Wait, you just saw him drink his own piss, and now you're going, what's with this guy?
He's jerking off in the bathtub.
He's nuts.
He's a weirdo.
No, here's the thing. We've already forgotten, and we accept him again as a human.
How is that?
No one else we know could come in here, drink their piss, and then we're discussing things with them again.
No, that's what had to happen. I was a little thirsty.
Yeah. How is the well, the Coke chaser must have helped you out a little
bit. I still have the worst. I'll tell you what, piss has a terrible aftertaste.
I've got the middle taste and the beginning taste.
That's only the diet piss has the bad aftertaste.
It's like tab.
Exactly.
It's like the tab of urine.
Tab was bad.
He didn't even get the Coke chaser. He tried so fast to go from piss to Coke, and he just spit the piss out all over the place.
I don't know what I've been eating lately, but it's not
shit.
Good.
Shit.
You've been eating those pills.
No, I mean, just the piss tasted so bad. I can't.
You don't think it came from the pills that turned your fucking piss gold?
I don't know. I'm not a doctor. But...
You're taking pills for shit that you don't know what it is.
Yeah. Two different types of antibiotics, in fact.
Antibiotics. I love it.
One in the morning and then
stop it.
Three.
It's not even like it's an accent.
No. That's actually, I think, the way it's supposed to be pronounced.
All right. Yeah. I'll change it. I'll
yeah, we're
well,
all
you say antibodies.
Right.
Antibiotics.
And Aunt B was, was there with the whole gang.
We don't say antibiotics.
Yeah.
Kind
of your whole theory there.
I don't understand.
Yeah, don't well, that to. Makes sense.
You don't have to understand. That's the beauty of it. Careful you're grabbing the right thing that you're drinking out of.
I've got to.
Don't drink any more piss.
I think he's got the taste for it now.
Yeah. So I owe him 11. I owe you 11 bucks straight now.
It doesn't seem worth it after I contemplated.
11 bucks.
Spoonful of shit gets you an even 20, my friend.
No, I'm not going to be a shit eater.
Not again.
No.
Come on, brown boy. You know you want to do it.
Again?
No. I'll eat someone's blood.
What?
I
will do it if you take it right out of their neck. If you bite them on the neck and
Where's
suck
Pepper
it out.
Where's Pepper Hicks? It's like some kind of fucked up Monty Hall, let's make a deal thing that he does.
I'll drink blood.
I need money.
What? Now, here's the thing. This is the shit that later they run as a transcript and they make you feel bad about yourself.
Yeah, if you read this, it's really bad.
Right.
We've done things on the air where as you're doing it, it's a laugh riot.
Right.
And then you read a transcript of it and go, who the fuck did this? Who said this shit? And then, you realize it was me.
The problem is they don't type in background laughter. Everyone enjoyed
it. Right, yeah. Everyone was laughing during this one. He then picked up the bottle and drank his own piss to the guffaws of the crowd.
To the hoots and hollers. 3 hours later, he dropped dead. And then there was no more laughter.
Ron Bennington, Fez Watley. It's the Ron and Fez Show. It's the best of Ron and Fez on XM202.
You did a story last week, Fezzy, about, who was it?
Crazy Dick Van Patten.
Mm-hmm.
And he's pushing a new line of dog food. I'm not sure exactly what it is. What's it called?
Van Patten's Best?
Yeah, Natural Balance. Dick Van Patten's Natural Balance, which sounds like something that makes him mud. But he said this dog food is so good, and it's so good for your dog, that humans could eat it. And while he's pushing this at like a dog food trade show, he takes a big bite of the dog food.
I will tell you this. I don't care if I'm one of the elderly and I'm starving, I will rob a bank before I sit down and open up dog food the way you hear some old people doing. I will become a cannibal before I start eating dog food. I'll eat a baby.
I really wish he had saved some of his Ada's Enough money, because now he's eating dog food on TV.
Well, the champ and Harry said they will both eat anything, and you guys would be willing to eat some dog food today?
Yes, we have actually, the beef.
They said they'll eat anything Dick Van Patten eats.
Mm.
We have the beef formula with fresh carrots, brown rice, and fresh potatoes.
Mm-hmm.
And we also have the chicken formula with carrots, rice, and potatoes.
Here's what I don't understand. Why would a dog need carrots and rice and potatoes? That's for a person.
Wouldn't that create really bad mud for a dog?
I don't think it's a healthy thing for a dog to eat things that he wouldn't eat if humans never gotten involved in the world.
Yeah, you don't see a dog out in the wild like a wolf or something digging up a carrot.
A wolf isn't a dog, my friend.
It's not?
Mm-mm.
What
wolf,
is it?
A wolf is a wolf.
Oh.
Hence why they call them wolves. You're thinking more of a dingo or wild dog. All right, let's open this stuff up.
Did you say dingo?
No, I said guinea. So let's open this up and see what you got here.
Oh, it's not even.
Yeah.
God, you open. I'm left-handed. This fucking can opener.
The champ can't open up a can.
Well, left and right handed.
You need to go to the leftorium.
I understand, but you grew up on this planet. You understand. Well, how do you get out of doors?
This smells awful.
Yeah, why wouldn't it? It's dog
it
food.
It smells like dog food.
You're just standing next to Harry.
You know what? My parents had a dog. Sometimes I would have to feed it. I would almost throw up from opening up cans. Now, Earl, are you going to have some of this as well?
Hell no.
Why not?
Why? We're having lunch today.
I'm gagging. Oh, God, I'm going to get sick.
Earl, you should smell this stuff.
I don't put it on a plate. That grosses me out. I want you to eat it right out of the can. And no
like gentlemen.
No fork. I want you to put your mouth up there.
Your snouts.
Let me see, Harry. You take a big spoon of it first.
You get the chicken, Harry?
Yeah. Yeah, you take pictures of it.
No, I get the beef. That oh, it congealed on top. That's disgusting.
Yeah, that bone marrow jelly.
Yeah, go for it. Go.
It's good for you.
Oh,
that was a big spoonful. Ah.
How's it taste, Harry?
Pasty. It doesn't taste like chicken or doesn't taste like food. It's just like
and
dirt.
And he's tasted all of it.
You probably should have mixed it up a little bit before you just dug in.
Perhaps.
Yeah.
In hindsight, maybe.
Yeah. So they're eating dog food straight out of the can like Dick Van Patten.
Now, Dick Van Patten did not have that same reaction. He loved it.
Out of all the out of the Eight of Enough girls, you know which one I'd take?
Who?
Elizabeth. Elizabeth, the little dancer. Oh, look at the heaping spoon the champ has. Way bigger than Harry.
That's the beef formula.
Yeah.
I got the beef formula. Yeah. Hold on.
All right, there you go.
This is going to fucking suck.
Wow, that's a big mouthful.
And Fezzy, I just caught a whiff of it. It smells so bad.
Oh, man. Alpo breath.
I'm having trouble. Earl, you okay, buddy?
Earl's not there. Where is
he? Oh. Earl's moved away. He's fanning himself.
That's fucking just...
Disgusting or good?
Or Van Patten-alicious. That's Van Patten-tastic.
There's something crunchy in it, apparently.
All right, now look, Danny has to eat pizza.
Ew, Danny, you're gross.
That's Dick Van Patten dog food pizza.
Come here.
All right, stop
we
throwing.
We don't throw
don't make
food.
A mess. Don't make a mess,
I'll
champ.
Clean it up.
I don't want you to clean it up. I don't want you to make a mess.
I won't make a mess.
This is where we work. All right, take another big gulp for yourself.
And
where's Paulie, the other intern? Why can't he come in and enjoy some? He's left out of everything now.
And his coat needs some help. It's not as shiny as it should be.
That's true. Here's Walter. Walter, you're on Running Fez.
Man, my dog eats anything under the sun, boys.
You know,
give that dog olives, carrots, salad.
Well, here's the thing.
Cat turds out of the cat box. He will eat anything you give him, man.
Well,
that's
good.
What they're acting like. One thing is better than the other. But if your grandmother dies and goes on the and lies on the floor, the dog will come by and eat her face off. This has happened time and time again. It actually happened to one of our producers' grandfathers.
So you're
not one of these guys.
Really?
Previous producers, yes. You knew the whole story.
I don't remember it.
Mm. Try that. It's crunchy and it tastes a little burnt. So try the beef.
These guys are like Zagats right now. They're just going over it. Which one is better, the chicken or the beef?
We'll let you know in a second.
Yeah. I'm trying the beef now.
There's a tuna. You might like to try that.
Oh, shit, man.
Yeah, that's terrible. You can't even swallow that.
Don't spit it out. Bad dog. Bad dog.
Get in your bed.
It smells and tastes like shit smells.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like that, like...
Fezzy, just take a smell. You don't have to taste it. But just take a smell
of what he ate. The beef one is horrendous. Yeah. Hold on.
Hand me the can.
So the chicken, a little more edible than
the beef. I thought the beef would be better than the chicken,
you would think.
And I was dead wrong.
All right, here goes Fezzy.
Oh, God, does that smell like ass?
It smells like shit, like dog shit.
But not even, like stale, like not even fresh.
It smells like a litter box, but with a smoky aroma to
it. Yeah.
Like a hickory smoked cat shit.
So, like, if a cat was on nicotine, what its shit would smell like.
Yeah.
I bring in Paulie.
Here you go. Take this back, please. That is bad. Bad, Dick Van Patten.
I mean, to a dog, it might not be bad. For a human
is where
we run into trouble.
I'm going to try the chicken. Hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on. The chicken.
What I like about him, he takes a heaping spoonful.
That's not that
Just
bad.
Just fills it.
It's not that bad.
Take one more.
Put it on some toast.
The chicken they all like.
Yeah.
Chicken's not bad. It's not as crunchy.
All right, here comes Paulie. He's like, why am I left out? He's the guy that Everybody thought has more experience than the champ. He's going to do well. Nothing.
Come here, you big retard. Come on.
All right. Which one do you want to eat, Paulie? Chicken or beef?
You're eating the beef.
Which one is which?
Smell. Take a smell of each first.
Give us a smell first.
Take a big smell into the can. Where are you going, Paulie?
It smells like fucking cat food. I don't know why it's
It smells going. Like cat food. I have like that's grosser to you than dog food. What do you care?
Get a heaping help.
Yeah, he wants a clean fork. Like that matters when you're eating dog food.
You don't get germs.
No, I don't.
Dog germs.
Considering where other people's mouths have been, I have no idea.
What does that mean?
I don't know. Some people like eating ass around here.
Some people like eating ass.
There's nothing wrong with eating an ass.
Who likes eating the ass champ. Here?
The champ. Tells him stories in the back and makes him just get nervous. Not you. He likes eating ass, but not yours, Paulie. Don't worry.
He still has the breath and the fucking.
I don't have ass breath.
You're eating dog food and you feel like you're above him.
I haven't taken a bite yet, so right. I'm still one up on him.
All right. Say yummy and yummy before you eat it, Paulie.
Yummy, yummy.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know if I can.
Get it in there, big man.
Do it fast and easy. Oh. Fast and easy. Paulie the dog food eater.
Yeah.
Just
like
think
that.
Of it like a dog food. Oh,
Jesus. You eat this, then we go get a chew toy for you.
Can I?
You want that?
Please?
A squeaky steak?
And later you can jump on me when I come home from work. You can be all fucking happy.
Now you're just stalling. Go. Yes. Just do it.
I certainly am.
You got to get it about 7 inches closer
to
your mouth.
I can't.
You act like we should swallow a dick here. It never happened.
I can't dig.
You're having some dog food. Yeah. What's the big deal? You're the one who asked for it.
You're having some dog food. He goes, yeah.
Here we go, big man. Big Paulie. Having a big snack.
His hands are shaking. Shit. His hands are actually shaking.
Come on, Chuck Wagon.
Do it for Dick Van Patten.
Oh, only for him, I'll do it.
Yeah.
And you guys.
Why?
Yeah. I don't know.
You want to be the champ, right?
Oh. There he goes. Oh. Oh. He spit it right back.
Did you spit it out, Paulie, or did you swallow?
He didn't even get it in his mouth. He's.
Paulie, come here and talk to us.
Get over here.
You're wasting dog food.
I'm sorry.
And you got fleas. We were going to take you for a flea dip after the show.
What kind did he have, champ?
He had the beef. He couldn't
handle it. Did you swallow any of it?
Yeah.
I don't think you did.
You did not. You did not eat your dinner. Eat your dinner.
I can't.
Did you go on the carpet?
Sorry.
Just rub your
Lay
nose
a paper
in it.
Down for him, just in case. All right, have some chicken.
No.
Wait. I'm the one who says things. No.
All right, here you go. Bunch of chicken.
The chicken's
no,
not big.
I ain't bit. Having that much.
Oh, you're
it's
such
like a giant
Doesn't
meatball
matter. You spit anyway. You like chicken, right?
No.
Never?
Not like this. I don't.
You don't like chicken.
Oh, don't worry. It's not chicken food. It's chicken. Dog food chicken.
What's wrong with your hands?
He's trying to psych himself up.
Yeah, no, like, it's all...
I'm this like is a natural balance. This is the best food you've ever had. Hey, I thought you were Italian. What is your background?
I'm a little bit of everything. Italian, German, Irish.
You got to be Polish.
All right, my Kraut Mick friend. All right, you ready with this?
No.
It's either this or I put on Billy Staples' album. One way or the other.
Eat your dog food.
I have to eat my dog food now. I certainly have to eat
Seriously,
my dog
Seriously, you don't like his album? It's a
I've
filthy
never
Christmas.
Heard it, but I've heard things, and I'd rather eat dog food. From what I've heard, it adds up to a 10, but not in a good part.
See, that's Fez's critique coming back.
I said,
every song
from
a one.
I heard, yeah. I would have given him credit.
Eat the goddamn food.
Put some more on there.
No. If I'm eating, I'm eating like
go
this.
Go ahead, big man.
I'm eating portions.
All right, here we go. On three, ready? Open the hangar. Here comes the airplane. Airplane full of dog food. Ready? One.
There's a dog flying
two,
that plane.
Two, three. There we go.
Eat it.
Don't
spit.
Swallow.
Eat it. Eat your dog food. Eat your dinner.
Is it good or bad?
It tastes like shit.
No. That's no commercial. You're doing a live read right now for Dick Van Patten.
Take two. We're going to get it right.
Why can Dick Van Patten eat this, and these guys are acting like it's a big deal?
Dick Van Patten ate this thing at a dog show and smiled.
All right, here's what you can do now. You're going to have a big plate of the beef, or the champ mounts you from behind and treats you like a bitch. Which do you want? What do you want?
The bitch or the beef?
Come on, what do you want?
Staples album.
It's up to you. Would you rather be mounted?
I'll give it to you, champ.
Me champ now, big man?
Yeah.
You'll be my little champ.
All right, ready? Put your hands on the table. Hands on the table, then.
Grab your ankles.
Assume the position.
Here we go. What do you want?
It's third grade all over again.
You want some sloppy?
Oh,
no, fuck that. I ain't doing it.
Doggy food, doggy style.
What do you want?
What's it going to be?
It's a doggy choice.
I have lunch to get.
I can
wait.
We're
not going to let you go get it, you filthy bastard.
Yeah. You walk in there smelling like dog.
This smells horrendous. Oh, it's in my cut. It's in my cut right now.
Is it really?
Oh. Yeah, it's in
How'd
my
it
cut.
How'd it get down your pants?
Hey, RCA, you're on Ron Fez.
You boys forgot your manners. You should have offered the ladies the first taste.
You know, it's really true. Would you ladies like to have a little bit?
Nicole, Tina?
I'd like to hear their opinion on the tastes and texture of the dog food.
We got to do it.
Yeah, you really want some?
We gotta do it.
All right, go ahead, ladies.
All right, enjoy some of this Dick Van Puppies.
Grab.
Which one's the chicken? I'm only eating the chicken.
Hold on. Let me get
it. It all tastes
dish.
Like chicken anyway.
She's a big chicken.
And a little tiny bit.
Like any of it's really
she is
meat.
One. If you just do a forkful, it'll impress us.
I'm so petite. I really.
She ate before she got here. She had a fucking milk bone before she came in.
Where's my energy shake to wash it down? Oh, my God.
See, this is why I can't have an animal in my house. It's too disgusting. Ready on three. Ready?
Wait,
both
I
your girls.
I just have to say one thing.
Yeah.
This looks exactly like the French meat stuffing that my grandmother used to make for Thanksgiving.
You must have been
well,
very happy
taste
in that
like
family.
That.
Yeah.
But I never ate it.
All right. Ready on three.
Okay.
One, two, three. Oh. Women eating dog food.
Nobody seems to want another bite.
And still took it better than that fucking Paulie.
Paulie.
Still did a better job.
He ran away.
He is a puss.
Yeah, he had a bone to hide.
How was the chicken one?
Earl, how you doing, buddy? Earl's been throwing up, and you're not even in this room.
It's awful.
Take some over to Earl and see if he just... Earl, if you have one little... Talk to me.
Yes.
One. Hey, look at
yes.
me.
Yes.
One Mouth. Little forkful, and you'll be fine.
I'm gagging.
And you'll probably get over all this nausea problems of yours.
God, it reeks.
I think it's good for bleeding ulcers.
Or
it patches
them.
Yeah.
Or causes them. Oh, God, put it away from me. Get it away from the board.
No
you don't
burping
want any?
In the car.
Here's Tom. Tom, you're on Ron Fez.
Yeah, I just want to let these people know what they're eating. It's not only just beef, it's donkey, it's horse, any kind of animal that just died on the farm.
No, that's not true. Whatever, what's in there, Fezzy? Read the ingredients. If you're eating horse or donkey, they got to let you know.
Yeah, the chicken. I mean, it starts out chicken broth, chicken liver, carrots.
Delicious.
Oat bran, brown rice, potatoes, canola oil.
Mmm, that's like cannolis.
I was right. Natural hickory smoke flavor.
Mmm, see?
And then all kinds of vitamins in it.
All right, so there's no donkey and horse, right?
No, none of that.
Why would they just load it up with donkey and horse? As if that was cheaper than chicken.
People think that they could just lead horses and donkeys into a factory and no one would notice.
David, you're on Ron and Fez. How you doing?
Good. How you guys doing?
Good.
Hey, you guys keep eating that shit. You're going to find them later on in the corner licking their balls. You know that.
Well, how much they got to eat before they start licking my balls? That's what I'm going for on this.
He smells your intern on you.
All right, champ, once again, you won again.
Yes, of course. I'm the champ. The champ stands up to any challenge, especially with Harry and Paul.
Paulie, on the other hand, he doesn't seem like he's going to be in for the long run.
I don't think he's going to make it. We're going to have to leave him behind.
What is he doing out there? He needs to run and get that food for Fez.
Mm-hmm. I don't know what he's doing. He kind of just takes laps around the office sometimes.
You got to stop him. Send him out of here. Let him know he's got to get right back.
Have him fetch my breakfast. Like I'm caught in a bear trap, and he's got to go get my lunch. Go get it, boy.
Here's Matt. Matt, you're on Ron and Fez. How you doing, pal?
Hey, how's it going?
Yeah.
Just going to let you guys know, your dogs are supposed to eat vegetables and whatnot. It's not, they're not just meat, not like them fucking cats.
Why should they eat vegetables? They wouldn't if they were in the wild, though, right?
Oh, yeah, they would.
And not like with most animals, maybe I'm wrong about this. Most animals eat either meat or they eat vegetables, right?
Right. I thought, yeah, carnivores and herbivores or whatever.
Besides us, does anybody else split it up?
I don't know of anyone else.
Yeah.
Maybe a pig, but I thought they were mostly vegetables.
A pig would eat anything, but let's suppose it was...
If it was just on its own.
Yeah.
It would probably just root and eat plants. Yeah, it would be just vegetables. I don't know if there's another one that mixes it up.
What does a wild boar eat? They just eat vegetables? How do they get that fucking fat off of just eating vegetables?
Yeah.
You know what you would think to yourself?
Yeah, they must store it a lot better.
What? Better? I don't think it's such a good idea for them. Here's, let me go to Ted. Ted, you're on the Ron and Fez show. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, boys. How y'all doing?
Cool.
Hey, you know, Champ, I was going to tell you, you know what that crunchy stuff is you keep eating?
What's that?
That's penis cartilage.
That's part
of the dick.
First of all, it wouldn't be the first time for the champ.
Not the first time.
Yeah. Here's Dan. Dan, you're on Run a Fez. How you doing, buddy?
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hey.
Hey, when I was a kid, man, my mom couldn't keep me out of the meow mix, man.
What a thing to say.
Now, how come? It just smelled good to you?
Long time pot smoker, man.
Meow, 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 meow.
Do you know, do it at what age?
One? Huh?
What age?
Oh, I was young, man. I was like 5, 6, 7. I was munching on that, hanging around the uncles.
I mean, when you're 7, you're smart enough not to eat cat food.
Yeah, he thinks it's Chex Mix.
Well, yeah. But when I was like 19 or 20, I was really baked, and I went to the refrigerator to make a tuna sandwich.
Yeah,
and my mom asked me if I get the cat food out of the refrigerator.
Yeah,
and I was eating it, and I didn't even know it. Right. Thought it was bad tuna.
See, that's another thing too. I can't stand it when people, like, if they didn't use the whole can of dog food or cat food, they put it in the refrigerator next to the people food.
Why wouldn't you eat a whole can? Once you open it up, give the dog everything in there.
No
dog is going to turn away food. Earl, you didn't want any of that dog food.
No.
You can't talk still.
I'm like dry heaving. I'm sorry.
We're going to have to start you out like on bird seed and work you up to dog food.
40% of the time with this show, you're not able to talk as the producer. Hey, Bobby, come in here and take this can out. It's disgusting. You're leaving it in the middle of this. Fez is waiting for his food. The man had a heart attack. You can't leave dog food around for him to eat.
Make sure I won't leave it out next time.
Yeah.
Oh, God, what a dope.
Fez, you're talking to the champ.
It's the fucking mic. It's not me. That's why I was holding it before, because it always just falls. I didn't want it to fall during the show, which kind of didn't fucking avoid it now.
Yeah, it's the mic's fault. It's the mic's fault we're in Iraq. I understand.
Here's Carl. Carl, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, hey, you got them eating dog food. You need to send somebody down and go get them some milk bones for an afternoon snack.
Yeah.
That would make Polly's teeth a little shinier.
Ted, you're on Run of Fez. How you doing, Teddy? Going once, twice. All right, you're out of here, pal. Here's Sally, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hi. The milk bones are very good. They taste like Triscuits without salt.
Let me tell you, honey, half the things you stuck in your mouth, a milk bone would be a step up.
Finally putting milk in front of it.
Go on somebody's leg.
Yeah, there it is.
Oh, your husband's home. Jeez.
This is disgusting. These interns are disgusting anymore. They come in, they go, please, can we eat some dog food? It's the first thing Harry's done on this show for a month.
He was begging for it.
Begging, couldn't wait.
He will not turn down a meal, no matter what it is.
I can see it. It kind of tasted like Armenian food, come to think of it.
I'd rather eat that over Armenian food. I'd be having puppy chow before I sat down and had any Armenian food.
When it comes out, it'll smell like his house.
Armenian food, to me, it just seems like it would be leftover carp.
Yeah, an old carp.
Carp head. Like carp that they found on the beach.
Carp that the Turks threw away.
All right, here's Mike. Mike wants to teach us a little science. Mike, you're on Ron Fez. How are you?
Great, guys. Thanks for taking my call. I hope these assholes realize what they're eating. Right now, on board my truck, I have 16 bins of cow navels and 4 bins of cow lips. Bon appetit, boys.
See you later.
Wouldn't it say lips or navels on the can?
What's the difference? Everybody eats sausage, and God knows what that is. And you got to admit, it's delicious. Matt, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, what's up, Ronnie?
Yeah.
Hey, man, I just wanted to point out you guys were talking about the herbivores and the carnivores. You also have the omnivores, which are the eat both vegetables and meat, such as the bear. You know,
all right, the bear will do that.
You got your fish. It eats your twigs and berries and shit in there. Also known to drive hybrid cars. See you.
All right, there you go. So,
yeah,
a bear will do it all.
Yeah, because a bear will fish like a salmon out of the stream and then also have like a pie that they steal off a windowsill later
on. Yeah, I don't count what any animal will do once they get it from a human. That's cheating. Yeah. What they get on their own, to me, is what naturally they will do. Because a horse will eat a hamburger if it's hungry enough. But it wouldn't know how to get a hamburger on its own. It can't fucking order. That's for sure.
I'd like to see one try.
Earl, how you feeling, big dog?
Starting to settle down a little. Oh, just
next time that you're sleeping in here, we're going to slip a little dog food into your mouth. Because there are so many pictures of you, Earl, napping on the job going around.
And they're all Bill. Bill always dimes me out.
They all look like Grampy fell asleep in his chair watching TV.
Bob, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Good.
I just want to call and say hi to Nicole and Tina.
Oh, sure.
Hey.
Hey.
You got fans.
Who's this?
This is her husband.
Hey, Bob, I got to tell you something.
It is.
Your wife has been throwing presents and cash around like I've never seen anybody. She's buying us lunch. She's handing us gifts.
What's going on there, Bob?
She thinks 50% of my income is hers.
You know, here's what you should do. You
that's
better.
Right. It is.
You better check the accounts right now, because I've never seen anybody come in throwing money around like this.
Depleted.
She's like, your money is no good here. Fez, what did you order for lunch?
I got the veggie burger deluxe.
I ordered the leather jacket. So I hope. Somebody else is ordering Fez, go large. Yeah. Go large.
Well, I just wanted to call and say hey and hope she's entertaining you.
Why don't you do this? Why don't you talk to her when she gets home? I mean,
yeah,
right
really.
Now she's on the radio. How long have you guys been married?
10 years.
Yeah. You lucky to get out of it?
No.
Okay.
But he needs to go back to work to save the country.
Oh, what do you do, Bob?
I work for the government.
Really? Which one?
Yours.
All right, good.
Hooray.
Because if I found out you were an evil agent, what kind of work do you do? You keep an eye on terrorists?
You got it.
All right, good. Is he really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Here's what I don't want to tell you guys how to do your job. But, you know, look at the Arabs closest of all. That's my thing. Generally, I would look at an Arab.
But he's not profiling.
No.
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 How is profiling a bad thing?
If you know who's, like, don't they profile all the time? Like, if there's a serial killer out there that's killing, you know, co-eds, they'll profile.
Yeah.
But here we don't know. That's the difference.
Yeah, we have to say we don't know.
All right, talk to you later, Bob.
All right, bye.
So he's like a secret agent then, right?
Yeah.
Nice.
Mm. Unless you're married to him.
And then it's not the same.
No good. Mm. Good, no good.
You
good.
Guys like Mr. and Mrs. Smith?
Heck no.
Oh.
Look at me. Do I look like Angelina Jolie to you, Fez?
Sure.
Come on.
The way you're throwing that cash around, I'll call you any name you want.
She put a 50 in Master Poe's jacket today on the way in.
You're looking great, Poe. Here, go out and buy yourself a new gi. How's everybody doing? Everything all right? We'll take a break. We're right back. Ron and Fez.
It's the Ron and Fez Show. It's the best of Ron and Fez on XM 202.
Is Garrett going to tell us something about that eBay thing today? Let me see. Hey, Garrett, you're on Ron and Fez?
Is that Ron?
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing, Ron? Love your show.
Thanks, buddy.
All right. My first question is his name Fez or is it Fezza?
Fezza.
Because every
with
time
a Z.
You always either say
no,
it with
it's
a
Fezza.
Z.
Fezza.
Yeah, that's or sometimes you do say Fez.
Yeah, well, you know, because that's like my little nickname for him.
Yeah, it's like Liza.
I love it. It's great.
It's Liza with a Z, Fezzy with a Z.
See?
And I'm like, well, the David Guest.
It's like three.
What were you going to tell us about that eBay thing today?
Well, the eBay thing, I was going to, if I had, you know, my wish, I'd bid on either the Batman number one, the first Batman comic.
Now, that's big money, right, Fez? I don't follow the comic things like you do, but.
Yeah, that thing's huge money.
Well, it's got to be huge. The other thing is either the snow globe or the sled from Citizen Kane.
Well, you know.
That's a good one.
Spielberg bought the sled years ago.
Did he?
And, yeah, for like $200,000 back in like the 80s. And I'm like, excuse me, I watched the movie. The sled went into the fire. So
the
I don't know what the hell you bought for $200,000.
Hey, that's a good point. Rosebud burned up.
And the globe broke.
Shattered, yeah. So, yeah. Like that, either one. And then if it was rock and roll stuff, I would go for the toilet that Elvis expired on.
God bless Elvis, huh? Poor man.
I wouldn't mind having a jumpsuit.
A soiled jumpsuit, maybe?
Or at least a cape.
Yeah. But listen, you guys are great, and I tell you what, you're so pleasant to your callers, even when you get the doofuses, you know, and they don't have
shut
a
up.
Point.
No, I'm only kidding you, brother.
I knew I was.
Well, no, I know. Well, we like the people who call the show.
Yeah, we're always nice to the doofuses. You have a good evening.
Oh, thank you, guys.
All right, see you later.
All right, take care.
All right, so he wants two things that were destroyed.
The sled and the snow globe from Citizen Kane. Let's see. For me, I'm trying to think. You know what?
If I could have anything, I would really want the cross that Christ.
Ooh.
I'd love to have that. I have even the perfect spot in my living room.
Really? You just put it right up there?
Yeah.
I think with that, something like that, you would build a room around it anyway. And you'd decorate to it.
Well, I have a mannequin, too, that I think would work. No. All right. I'll let you go first, Fizz.
Okay. If I could have anything, any sort of memorabilia.
Yeah.
Going movies?
Yeah, let's go movies instead of sports, because sports, we're all going to say the Babe's uniform. What else
there
is
you go.
There? What else is there?
I think it would be really cool to have the oil can from The Wizard of Oz. I would like the oil can.
The oil can from, more than the ruby slippers?
Yeah, more than the ruby slippers. To me, the ruby slippers are a little played. I think everybody would like
because
the ruby slipper.
Electric Light Orchestra had that the album cover, that great album cover, where it was shocking. I love that album cover. Wow.
I was,
you know, I'd never even thought of Wizard of Oz stuff.
Yeah, I wanted to think something really, really classic. I mean, because I could go, you know, like the Riddler's cane that Jim Carrey used.
Yeah, but that would be cool.
I would love wanted something if I could have one piece.
I would be, you know, I don't think it has to be. Here's what I think. It doesn't have to really be old. It has to really matter to you. And I remember the guys like Siskel and Ebert, the one who died. Which one was he?
Siskel died.
Mm. All right, so Gene Siskel, he had picked and bought years ago the suit from Saturday Night Fever. And, you know, it went really up in money and stuff because, you know, people weren't really buying memorabilia back then. But he said the fact was that the movie meant so much to him.
Oh, that's
you know, that's
cool.
Why he got it. Not to buy it and sell it and have something.
Right.
But to just look at it.
Well, the Riddler's cane would actually do that for me, but I would love that oil can as well. You know what I actually saw the other day?
Yeah.
I was going to the bank, and I'm pulling into the shopping center. No lie, across the intersection, the Batmobile pulls out of the shopping center from the Batman TV show.
Was it a real one, or somebody, or can you buy a package for him?
It looked real to me.
Was there trouble somewhere?
The only thing it didn't have on it is, like, the bat insignias on the side. Like those red Batman signals. But it had everything else, like those bubble windshields in the front and the back. It had the fins. It had the thing in the back. It looked really, really cool. And I couldn't believe the Batmobile was pulling out in front of me.
Fez, for me, and by the way, Fez also owns some like little lamp that he makes a little bat insignia on the ceiling of his house like a maniac.
It's a working bat signal. You light it up and you can actually shine it on your roof. On your ceiling.
You ought to do it on your neighbor's house just to scare him.
There is trouble in Gotham City.
What about for you, El Jefe?
What movie memorabilia would you like, buddy?
I had two that popped into my head. The first one was The Briefcase from Pulp Fiction.
That's a good one.
That's really cool. That's a good idea.
I just want to know, what was in there?
If you bought it, you weren't.
I know for a fact, because I know somebody who knows Tarantino. But I'll tell you after the show. I can't tell you on the That's my promise.
You swear?
No, I can't tell you, because you actually made me swear. And that always bugs me. But, you know, nothing. All right, go ahead.
The other one, I don't know where this came from. This is J-Dubs channeling through me. But the pinball machine that Jodie Foster was abused on
would
the accused.
Would you bang your check on it?
Maybe.
See, that's a problem.
That popped into my head, though. I'm like, wow, that'd be kind of cool. Well, it's cool enough to have a pinball machine, but to say that's the one Jodie Foster was taken on in The Accused.
Yeah, that's a good one.
All right, how about this? You made me think of this. Jackie Gleason's cue stick from The Hustler.
It's just like any other cue stick, Fezzy.
I know, but it was Jackie Gleason.
Well, just grab one and tell people. What are they going to do?
No, I would know.
Just scratch a little JG in it.
I couldn't live that lie.
When I lived in New York and family would come up whenever I was walking down the street, I would always, like, I would run out of things to show them. I would point at a bar and go, Gleason always drank there. And they would be like, oh, really? I go, yeah. Because you could get away with it in New York because he drank a lot of places. For me, I would pick the red jacket that James Dean wore in Rebel Without a Cause.
Oh, very nice.
Which
very
was
cool.
Really the start of teenagers. There were no teenagers in America until he wore that jacket. Here's Jay. Jay, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Jay.
Hey, Ron Fez. How you doing? I originally told your screen guy that I wanted any lightsaber from the Star Wars movies, right?
Were they not real?
Yeah, well, tell my grandfather that.
Yeah.
But first of all, Fez, my condolences to you and your family. I heard about the loss the other night, and that's horrible. So
yeah, it's very sad.
What,
about
that?
Your fiance jumping off Niagara Falls. I feel bad about that.
I thought you meant the pit bull that we had to put down. But go ahead.
And I would love the whip that they used in the movie Roots to beat that black guy up with. I think I'd like that. You know what I mean?
All right. You know what? You're going to get this.
White people are so scared of black people.
It's just meanness. And he went away without even me hanging up on him. Because he's ashamed.
Because he knows what he did. If I was going to get a whip, I think I would use Indiana Jones's.
Just stupid. You know we're friends with Earl, and you hurt his feelings. Will, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Will.
Hey, I was going to say the whip, too, from Raiders of the Lost Ark, but you just said it.
Oh, no, that whip is fine.
Yeah,
that'd be cool to have that whip from Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Wouldn't you rather have the jacket, though? Or the hat?
Oh, the hat.
I mean, maybe the combo. The whole combo.
I know you want the outfit.
The fedora would be cooler than the whip, I think, for me.
Yeah, you got to have the whole package, really, though. But, yeah, that'd be cool.
All right, see you, brother.
Hey, thanks, man.
You know what? In all honesty, Fez, the thing that I wouldn't even do is spend this big money on any of these things. Even though I would like to have them, I can't see spending too much when it gets into the really big money. Even if you think you're going to sell it later, it still bugs me. It still bugs me that something that cost $15 or $100 when it was made new is now worth $100,000. That gets on my nerves.
That's amazing. But if you have it and it would make you feel good to have it, I say spend it.
All right, so you're saying if you're Bill Gates. No, you know what? I don't want to be a sucker just because I have a couple billion dollars. I'd rather spend that money on hookers and dope and, you know, really invest it.
You have different collections.
Here's Sal. Sal, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, how you guys doing tonight?
Cool.
Good, buddy.
All right, I would want the stuffed horse's head from Godfather.
You know what? It does even kind of look stupid, even in the movie. If you go back and watch the movie, it doesn't look like a real head, does it?
Yeah, but you could hide it in people's beds. It'd be functional, too.
Yeah, that part I like.
You could probably do that with any horse's head.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Just go out and cut the head off.
You're going to save a lot of money that way.
What about something like from TV? Wouldn't you like to have one of the bee costumes that Belushi hated so much? Belushi's fat little bee costume?
That would be very cool to have.
Yeah.
I'd like that a lot.
Here is Paul. Paul, you're on Fez.
Hey, yeah, going back in The Godfather again. How about the gun that Michael used in the restaurant? And Fez, that's a kit car guy in McLean put together on a Cadillac.
So oh, it is? Deal.
Yeah.
So Fez didn't see D.
I saw a Batmobile.
But you saw a kit car.
Yeah, student McLean. He made his Cadillac look like that.
Well, he did a good job.
Look at you, Fezzy.
What?
Oh, you see an Elvis impersonator, and you're telling everybody you saw the king.
I saw the Batmobile, and it's all that matters to me.
Jim, you're on Ron Fez.
Yeah, I want Herman Munster's hot rod.
You know, that thing was always pretty cool. If you could have any of those vehicles, Fezzy, what would you want?
Oh, I would want the Batmobile. That would be mine.
Out of everything, all time.
Let me think. Let me go through it.
How about James Bond's car?
Nope. So rather have the Batmobile.
Why turn childish and act like we're 11? Can adults have this conversation?
Batmobile for me, my friend.
All right.
Pull it around front.
Why don't you get the fake one that you saw, that you've been making such a big deal about, and called your dad. By the way, at the Palm today, Fez and I ate next to former governor of Texas.
Ann Richards.
The great Ann Richards.
Like King of the Hill?
Like King of the Hill, yeah.
Yeah,
the same Ann Richards.
Most people know her from being governor of Texas, but yeah.
What's that?
Yeah. But you know her from a cartoon.
Fidel, did you have... Poor George.
Fidel, did you have something you wanted to end?
I do. From Taxi Driver, I don't know what you call it, but the wrist action shot, the gun thing that he made himself and fashioned out of...
Yeah, what the hell would that be called? Because it really just came off a drawer.
Yeah, the drawer, the track. But whatever you call that...
Yeah,
I
guess
that.
It's a track. Well, yeah, you're right. You are right with
driver,
the track.
Track.
If you can find it for me, please do.
I've seen a couple of real ones in my life, so maybe... Yeah.
Cool.
Here's Robert... Robert, you're on Ron Fez.
Hi. I think keeping in the weapons frame of mind, the axe that Jack Nicholson used in The Shining. Here's Johnny.
Thank you. The axe that Jack Nicholson used. See, to me, I mean, it's cool that Jack Nicholson had that axe.
Yeah.
But I need something a little bit more specific, a little bit more custom made from a movie.
One of a kind.
Yeah, exactly. Not just an everyday utensil that someone famous used.
Wait a minute. Aren't you the one that said that you wanted to pull stick from the Hustler?
Yeah, but that's Jackie Gleason.
See, now you're just finding a reason.
Talking about movie memorabilia, something you'd like to collect if you could have any one thing.
Bill, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, what's up, buddy?
Hey, my buddy.
Okay. I would really love to have the volleyball from Castaway.
Wilson?
Yeah, Wilson. That would be the best thing to have. Or the original hockey mask from the Friday the 13th.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
That is really cool.
Mm-hmm.
Wilson, I would actually was glad when it drowned. Right,
Wilson!
I swear, I hated the Wilson character. Even though it was just a volleyball with a blood stain, that Wilson bugged me so much that I was literally happy when it blew away.
I mean, if you watched that movie and you kept hearing him scream Wilson, didn't you keep thinking Rita Wilson?
I did, as a matter of fact. And I thought that maybe that's why it was supposed to be that. That, like, he was pretending Wilson was his lovely wife.
No, it was just too close to home. It kept breaking the reality.
It had no reality for me. That whole thing wouldn't happen. Look what year it is, Fez. We can find people. There are not islands where that no one gets found anymore. Hey, Amena, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, from my all-time favorite movie, Dawn of the Dead, I'd like the blood pressure machine where the guy got his arm ripped off in it.
You can get that for about $14. Thank you very much. It's the same one.
They sell them everywhere. Just put an arm in it.
Here's Mark, you're on Ron Fez.
I definitely have the Ferrari from Ferris Bueller's Day Off. That thing's bad.
I don't know if you saw what happened to it at the end, but you can probably get it cheap.
It is so choice.
It is so choice. He's going to call. He's going to call. He's going to call. I know it.
Rooney or Nahole?
Kyle, you're on Ron Fez.
What's up, buddies?
Bye-bye.
Hey, buddy.
What's going on? Hey, how about the twins outfit from the Matrix 2, the outfit that the twins wore?
You want both of them?
Yeah, why not? One doesn't fit.
You know, I never even understood that twins thing.
I think they were ghosts.
M. Steels would love Alex's cane knife from Clockwork Orange. You'll get busted with that, Steels. Mikey. Jenny Q would love Atticus's pocket knife. let me start all over, Fez. I'm pretending we don't work 12-hour days. Atticus pocket watch from To Kill a Mockingbird.
Okay, Atticus Finch.
Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. Is there a lot of Atticuses out there that you have to correct me? Oh, you must mean Finch.
I don't think I corrected you.
Ray, well, you updated me. Ray, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, how you doing? I'm thinking the Austin Powers penis enlarger.
You know, the Austin Powers thing means nothing to me. Nothing.
They make so many Austin Powers, this stuff should be selling, you know, it should be just plentiful. Should be out there everywhere.
Although he had a cool little car that you started to see people rip off. Here's Brian, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, guys.
Hey, buddy.
The car from Bullet, Steve McQueen's car.
That was a badass car. And maybe the best car chase stuff of all time. Even anymore, I don't even know if anybody even gets into the car chase stuff. John, you're on Ron Fez.
All right, I'm thinking the golf bag from Caddyshack that had the built-in boombox that Rodney Dangerfield had.
That would be a blast. And somebody has that. That's what's hysterical about it. That when they Caddyshack, probably someone on the crew just wandered off with it, no big deal.
And they just started blaring Journey.
Well, then let's dance. What song was that? Don't Stop Believin'?
Was it that? Yeah, I think it was.
I can't remember exactly. So stupid to just start blaring Journey.
You want to make something of it? No, I want to dance.
Ken, you're on Ron Fez.
No, no one's mentioned the massage table from Full Body Massage. What gives?
Yeah, we'd like to get that. Thanks.
Thank you for the call.
What was Full Body Massage?
I have no idea. I think that was a...
Look it up.
Probably a porn. He wants porn props.
I remember some massage movie with, why isn't IMDb coming up? With Tom Cruise's first wife.
Mimi?
Yeah, what was her name? Mimi?
Rogers?
Mimi Rogers, yeah. Where she was getting massaged by this guy every day. And it was like an erotic thing. God, were her breasts big. That's it.
That's the one. Same movie?
Yeah.
Full Body Massage.
Brian Brown was the other guy. Remember Brian Brown?
No, not at all.
Yeah, you do. FX.
FX.
You never saw the movie FX where he was a special effects guy and would fight the bad guys using special effects?
No.
Fez, write this down. This is right up your alley.
Really?
I'm going to guarantee you this. This will be one of your favorite movies.
All right. I will check this out. I never heard of this.
All right. Brian Brown, he also did Cocktail with Tom Cruise. Okay. And then he's with his ex-wife, just literally pawing her.
So this Full Body Massage, is there anything to this movie? Or is it just a massage, a really long massage?
I can't tell you there's a lot to it. I'm going to be honest with you.
It just doesn't seem like a lot to fill up a whole film with.
It worked for, I only saw the film, let's say, 7 minutes at a time over the course of. Here is Brian, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Brian.
Hey, guys, how are you?
Yeah.
First of all, the song from Caddyshack was Any Way You Want It.
Any way you want it, that's the way you need it. Thank you very much. And by the way, just for helping, because most people won't help Fez and I.
There's a winning cowbell. You're going to the big-ass prize closet.
Oh, okay. Thank you, guys.
Fez corrects me. You correct Fez, and we're all in business together. All right? We're all one big team.
You guys rock.
Yes, we do. What else were you going to bring up, Brian?
The broadsword from Braveheart, that big-ass sword he throws in the air.
Yeah.
That'd be cool.
Cool to mount that over your fireplace or something. I don't know.
Yeah, and then if you ever have trouble, you just bring that out.
Yeah, that's not something you're going to be able to just carry around and show to people.
Brian, line two... Let him go into the big-ass prize closet and just enjoy himself for helping out.
Let him get something nice out of there.
Here's Jennifer.
Hey, Fezzy. I want them airline pamphlets from Fight Club where everybody's burning up.
Why would you scare me? Seriously, Jennifer, what's wrong with you, honey?
That's all right, though, huh? We'll frame it.
You know Fez has a flying problem.
I love Fezzy. I'm going to go hold his hand next time he goes.
I can't wait to get on a crop duster with you.
Fezzy, next time you go, we're going to hold your hand.
I'm going to hold you. We're going to fly over Philly.
Hey, do this. Why don't you get him a glass of water?
Water.
and then we'll go up to Lancaster.
Yup. nah, Pensy.
Yeah. Huh?
Watch them race. Watch them race up in Pensy.
Watch them race up in Pensy,
get
Fez.
Get some cheesesteaks.
We'll get some cheesesteaks, and then we'll go in the house.
Come
Fez,
on.
You go in the house with me. I'm going to get some water.
Ronnie, you know you mess with them Jersey women. Come on, big hair, big hmm-hmm.
Yeah.
My gosh.
I take them two at a time.
You love
this
us.
Dump. Literally this dumb, Fez, and I'd be taking them two at a time.
That's right. We can handle it.
Yeah, well, I'd have to take it around back just to make sure it was, you know.
Around in the ear, wherever.
That's a nice motto to live by, honey.
That's right.
My gosh.
See ya.
See ya.
Thank you for the call.
A little ball buster. Jersey people, ball busters.
I wouldn't mind one of those Fight Club soaps. That they use.
Oh,
the
yeah, they were great, man. They actually should have used those as promos.
Just hand those bars of soap out as you go into the theater.
Fight Club, such a great effing movie. Do you know what movie, like, I know it didn't do good at the theater, but something I like watching at home on DVD is that Swordfish with John Travolta.
I know, that one I didn't see.
Fezzy, write this down. You got so much to catch up on. You got FX and Swordfish. I'm interested in seeing what you said. The opening scene of Swordfish, un-effing believable. And you're thinking, this is going to be one of the great movies of all time. And it kind of isn't.
Oh, okay.
But if you watch it on DVD, you can miss, you know, you can skip here and there.
Is that the one with Halle Berry?
Yeah.
She's in it?
Yeah.
Is Wolverine in that one?
Wolverine's in it and Johnny T.
Okay.
Johnny Travolta. So it's got everything you like.
Sure. What's not to like there?
And so's the little guy that we like so much from, God, my mind is just going on me. I'll come back to it, Fez, all right? I'm going to come back to it. You know, instead of just sitting here making you jump at me and make you correct me, I'll move on and I'll come back. Fez, here's our best friend, Lance, from Full Rock and Karaoke.
Hey, Lance, what's going on?
If I had to go old school, I'd take one of the vests from the Warriors, old Walter Hill.
Oh, Warriors! Come out and play.
All for a little piece of turf.
Yeah, what a great picture. Thanks, brother,
and
man.
You did it.
What a great picture that's a piece of crap. You know, and you got to watch it all the time. Ron Fez.
Ron Bennington. Fez Watley. Ron and Fez. Skawifa La Fafa. It's the best of Ron and Fez on XM 202.
Show. Getting a lot of emails here at ronandfez@aol.com, Fezzy, and I'm not going to lie to you. A lot of them trying to tear our idea apart.
Of two countries.
Yeah.
One red, one blue. So everybody gets to live the way they want to.
Right. Exactly. So we won't have to hear about an Armageddon anymore and the constant cultural war. It'll be just dropped.
Right. Because if you're in the red country, you're going to get to pick every Supreme Court justice you want that supports no abortion.
Right. If you're in a blue country, you get to pick the same way for your team.
Yeah, where you can have choice.
Everyone stops the crybaby stuff. But some people, I guess, they just want to fight.
Yeah, they're not happy unless they are.
Yeah.
That's a problem.
Yeah. They're not happy until somebody's crying. I keep saying the bird flu thing on TV, Fezzy. Is it real? Is this a gimmick? Is it something to scare us?
Well, this is what I don't understand. You know, we've seen how, like, in countries like Estonia or something like that, they found the bird flu, and you're like, yes, that's a dirty, disgusting place, and you're going to find bird flu there.
Estonia?
I think so.
And that's close to bedrock?
I don't think Estonia has existed in decades.
Somebody's making up things because they can't back up. All right, go ahead.
But they find it in foreign countries. Like, they find it in China and stuff. Mm-hmm. Well, now they found, like, 30 ducks mm-hmm. that had traces of bird flu in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
And they're saying, well, it's not the bad bird flu, so we tested them and released them. So those ducks are migrating mm-hmm. to the U.S., red and blue, for the winter.
They'll be going through the divided states of America.
And then President Bush, he unveils his bird flu plan, which sounds like, hey, I've started a new dance. It's called the bird flu.
Right.
So $6.5 billion to start with to battle bird flu. I don't think we can afford bird flu.
No, it's a lot of money for bird flu.
With the war in Katrina, we don't have an extra $6.5 billion. It's just, we're just going to have to go down to soup. And not chicken soup, because that's bird.
Yeah. Is bird flu worse than just a regular flu? Because it sounds to me, take a couple days off, throw up a little bit. You'll be fine.
Apparently, there's some strain of this bird flu that could just wipe out millions worldwide. The word pandemic has just all of a sudden been
everywhere.
Is that
another country you're making up? Pandemic?
Pandemic is a real word, and it's just a worldwide epidemic of disease where everybody has it.
Just a sickly, sickly planet.
Yeah. I heard this, and this is a real fact.
Go ahead, give it to me.
That every flu is a bird flu. That any flu that a person gets started in birds first.
How do they start? Because they used to be dinosaurs?
Yeah, I think it's something like from the fossil days or something.
See, the red states won't have to deal with this because they don't believe in dinosaurs. Earl, you can perfectly move there because you've never believed in dinosaurs.
But I like the blue states.
No.
You only believe in walking the dinosaur.
Everybody walks a dinosaur. Who did that song? Was it, is that?
It was not was.
Yeah, it wasn't.
Who not what?
Well, who was the spinoff band from the Talking Heads? That was Don was not was.
Oh.
Tom Tom Club.
Yeah, because that, I always get those confused. What did they do that was a big hit?
A Genius of Love.
Thank you very much. Thank God we have Earl. All right, so every flu comes from a bird.
Every flu that humans end up catching started as a bird flu, and then it gets airborne, obviously, because birds what? They fly.
They fly. I was going to say fly, but you really, it wasn't much of a pause. And as I leaned in to answer, you threw in fly. All right, Fezzy, I'm spitballing here. I'm brainstorming. And you know what? If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. Kill every bird.
Kill every bird? No one gets the flu again.
Here's what's going to ruin that for us is parakeets. You know people will be hiding parakeets.
Yeah.
Because for some reason, they feel like a parakeet is a pet and a hawk isn't or whatever. That kind of annoys me.
Right, yeah, because one of the birds that got sick last week that they found out had bird flu was a big parrot. You know, someone's pet.
I don't like a parrot, man. I had one in my house. My sister came up to buy this parrot. I guess she got it on eBay or one of those crazy-ass things. So she needed to stay at my house for a couple days because she got it in Queens. This parrot came in. Fez, I'm not kidding you. Its face was as big as yours.
Oh!
And here was the weird thing.
I hate a face.
It basically was just as expressive as yours. So It,
like it had eyebrows.
It did. It fucking was so weird. And if I was alone with this thing, I felt like it was really going to just, like, drop, you know, what it was doing before. Like, we're just repeating and just start talking to me. And I'd look over at it, and I would go like this. Go ahead and say it, motherfucker. If you got anything on your mind, now's the time to do it. Because it felt like it was an alien in my house.
Yeah, parrot, the things that bother me on a parrot, those claws.
Yeah.
Anyone who doubts the scientist's theory that birds came from dinosaurs,
right,
just look at those raptor claws that are on the bottom of a parrot. The one part of it that isn't covered with feathers.
You're exactly right. That's a raptor claw. Yeah. Definitely, 100%.
And it's just so gross looking. It looks someone's mangled foot, it looks like. And then a beak. A beak will freak me out because it looks like fine porcelain or something.
Yeah, like it could shatter.
Yeah, that's what gets to me about it. It looks like if that bird bites something too hard, its whole beak is going to shatter, and then there's just going to be a big hole in the parrot face.
Now, they don't have teeth, right? So it's like the whole thing is a tooth because it could crack a rock, those beaks.
Yeah, that beak, it's like jagged
on
the inside. So that's like, it's like two teeth. A top beak and a bottom beak part.
Oh. I don't like a beak either, man.
Yeah. And it just looks like it would crack like an eggshell.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then what's that? Then can you imagine the sounds that come out of a bird that has its beak busted?
No. I don't like you're right about birds. I don't like the flu. I don't like the beaks. I don't like the talons. There's not much I like about them. I hate that noise.
Yeah. I will. If it means getting rid of every bird, I'll eat steaks. I'll eat pork and steaks. I don't have to have chicken again. I rarely have duck. I don't think I've ever had goose.
Wasn't pork and steaks the name of your high school yearbook? Just the pork and steaks.
Well, yeah, for us, you know, the sick kids that got left back. Mm.
Hey, Perry. Perry, you're on Ron and Fez. How are you, buddy? What's up, Perry?
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing?
Good, man.
That's good. You know how many millions of fucking birds we got up here in Canada?
You mind keeping them to yourself?
Well, there's 30 out of, like, millions and millions. Those bastards are flying over us as I'm sitting here.
Yeah, I know. They just drop shit bombs on everybody.
Well, yeah.
They are filthy.
Nothing's worse than geese shit.
I mean, 30 out of millions and millions, and they got this flu that isn't even the bad one. I mean, it doesn't even count.
Yeah, it doesn't even seem like that should have made the news. It's not really the real flu.
Yeah, it's, trying to scare, because they let them loose again right back into the air.
See, that's the thing that you don't realize, Fez, is how many birds are out there. I just read this today. Somebody sent it to me. If you were to weigh humans, like every human on the planet, and weigh the ants... The ants would outweigh humans.
Really?
Yeah.
I mean, outnumber, you see that.
Right.
That's just obvious.
That's a gimme. But outweigh us. So how many ants do you think makes even a child? What do you think 60 pounds of ants, how many you got to get together?
I would say you would have to have a billion or so ants.
And they outweigh us. Pound for pound, the ants outweigh us.
It's the bugs you don't see.
I saw Tom the Cop went by. Now, here's the interesting thing today. The Ron and Fez show, and this is a perfect day for you, we're insecure. We've got nobody on our borders, no Master Poe. Totally unsecured today.
We're like the blue state country.
Now, last night, we had tons of security. Did you try to use the restroom, Fez?
I tried to use it once.
Security followed you.
Yeah.
To make sure you were safe. Pink.
Right.
Yeah. I never felt that you and I needed a lot of security. We're pretty under the radar, guys.
And we violate our own security anyway. Yeah, come on over. Get a picture. Come on over.
Yeah, break the security wall.
Oh, yeah, we want to talk to that drunk.
Right.
Eastside Dave, hand him over to us.
Now, speaking of which, did you see last night Eastside Dave was kind of shoved back a little bit for getting too close to me? He didn't really make any movements towards me, but in a secured environment... Eastside Dave is seen as an aggressive person.
I have to admit, that was one of my favorite moments last night. Just seeing Eastside Dave get the stiff arm from security as he tried to tap you on the shoulder to tell you just one more thing.
Yeah, he was doing that. I had to go back on the air, and he had kind of grabbed me and was giving me the wait, drunk thing. And he got the very nice stiff arm being kept back. And then he gave me, oh, I see. I see what you're doing now. Fine. Like, suddenly, I'm not the same guy.
He had a great shocked look on his face when he got put back, which was hysterical. And then it instantly turned to drunk outrage.
Right. It was that Irish thing of, oh, you're too good for my family now. It's always that thing, like, in an Irish family, if one of the people, it's why the lottery destroys people. Because if one person in an Irish family gets the money, all the rest of them, oh, so now he's acting like he can have white walls. You know, like everything isn't in front. Oh, I see your kids are wearing hard shoes. You don't have time for us anymore. You're using fancy napkins, cloth napkins. So that's what it turned into.
Heaven forbid someone gets a new coat.
Yeah. Does your family get that way where... They don't like if somebody, you know, suddenly gets... And in my family, it would be something as, oh, your dad with his new tool shed. He acts like he doesn't have a worry in the world with his brand new tool shed. It wouldn't even be something to brag about.
Yeah, my family totally like that. Yeah. Anytime someone dies, you have to hear this. I won't see a dime of that money.
Right.
Well, why should you? Was it your money?
Yeah.
Does that money belong to you? No. Mother constantly does that when someone kicks the bucket.
You call your mom mother?
Yeah, I do. Call my father dad. Actually, I call him Pop, and yeah. I call my mother.
That's what I call my dad Pop, too.
He turned into Pop when my sister had kids.
Yeah, it's always better. Yeah. It's always better when your dad becomes a grandfather, because then you get a nicer name for him. Mother, I would never call my mom mother. That's way too formal.
I always call her mother.
Now, is that a mean thing?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, and I mother.
See, I'm not comfortable with mother, and then I also don't like Earl's thing of mommy, where it's suddenly like you never got off the tit.
Too bad on two extremes.
Yeah, I mean, I need a really, it's got to just come into ma or mom.
Ma's good.
Yeah.
I like ma.
Yeah. Even though you don't do that formally, but like if you're calling her, ma.
When the Waltons were popular, I tried doing mama with my mom, and my sister just got furious with me.
Here's the thing that I never like, though, that people will do, is when they give like a grandmother a last name. Always has gotten on. You know, it'll be like, oh, did you say hello to Grandma Bernstein? I mean, you're basically making it way too formal.
That's totally how we did it.
Did you really?
We had Nana and Papa.
Yeah.
And whatever their last names were. So I know what their last names were.
Well, but here's the smart thing that you need to do. You don't all go with the same grandfatherly nickname. Like, you have a Pop-Pop and a Granddad. But if you're both going to be like Granddad Anderson and Granddad Monahan, then you're just fucking wasting time for the kids.
Yeah, with my 3-year-old niece, my mother is Grandma Carol. And then her
did you say hello to Grandma Carol? It's all but like having a step in the family.
And then the other grandma is just Grandma.
Oh. So that's the mom's mom, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's always the head of the
my sister-in-law's mom.
That's the head of the pyramid. You can't beat the mom's mom.
And that mother-in-law, she's like 15 years younger than my mother.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just so much more on the run with the baby. And hey, let's go to the zoo. And I'm taking you to the aquarium. And my mother's like, my feet hurt.
Yeah. Somebody want to rub Grandma Carol's toes for and crack them knuckles. You kids are too noisy.
I think the last time I was on, the conversation came up. The baby asked my mother, where's your mom? And so we had to go into the big, she's with the angels.
Right.
She lives with the angels speech.
I would always tell the kids to make them feel comfortable is, grandma's under the ground now. She's in dirt.
If you want to go to a cemetery, I'll show you where she's in dirt.
I'm going to teach you about death. Here's a film called Rambo. And this is what happens with death. You know, people get so uncomfortable around little kids around death.
Oh, yeah.
And just, you know, they're going to fucking believe whatever. You tell them what words are, and they have to believe them. You could raise a kid, tell him that a spoon is called scoop, and I guarantee you he's going to show up in fucking in kindergarten asking for a scoop like an idiot because he won't find out on his own.
And think every other kid is crazy for saying spoon.
You could just say, oh, yeah, grandma, when you die, you become a cartoon. And that fucker is going to believe it until somebody straightens him out.
Well, right now, this little baby is thinking that this old woman is actually living with a family called the Angels.
Right. She's playing in California now. You're Anaheim, are you familiar? Grandma is now an outfielder for the Anaheim Angels. Tom, you're on Ron Fez.
How we doing, guys?
Good, man.
Yeah, I call my grandma a nanny.
A nanny?
I don't know where I got it. Yeah, I don't know where I got it from or who gave it to her, but I call her nanny.
Huh. It sounds formal and yet babyish at the same time.
I'm 22. I still call her nanny.
Yeah.
You know what? I think I had I had a nanny that was like a great-grandmother.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And then I think my kids called my wife's grandmother Nana or Nan. Yeah, they just called her Nan.
Right.
Yeah, so that's the same thing. Do you ever do this, though? Like, some kids don't know that their grandparents will have, like, real weird names. Like, we all know Grandpa,
pop, pop, granddad. But then somebody will go like this. I have to go to my Peepaw's house. And you're like, what the fuck are you talking about? A Peepaw.
That was the name. That was the kids across the street. They had a Meemaw and a Peepaw. And you're like, what the hell?
One kid called his grandmother a bocce in my neighborhood. And I'm like, the cooking stuff? What the hell? What do you mean a bocce? Hey, Fez, do we have an intern named Zach in D.C.?
Yeah, his dad was 2-time Stanley Cup champion.
Oh, yeah.
With the Flyers?
Yeah, he sent something to Al Dukes. You know who would be, because Al Dukes is always looking for producers. You know who would be a good one was that Steve Perry kid that we never talked to again.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about him.
Yeah. I like that kid a lot.
Steve Perry Jr.
Actually, I wouldn't mind him having him here with us here. But he lives down in D.C., right?
Yeah. Yeah. So, but Zach was the one that would travel from Jersey to D.C. for his internship.
Yeah. Yeah, now I remember him. Hey, Steve. Steve, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, Steve.
Stevie.
Hey, guys. What's going on?
Yeah.
Hey, I used to call my grandmother Big Mom because she was my mom's mother, and she was larger than my mother.
Hey, Big Mom. Was she heavy?
No, she was just tall. She was 6'1".
Oh, geez. Then that was a Big Mom. There's no doubt about it.
Big Mama's house.
Why not just call her Stretch? Oh, yeah. I call my grandmother Yao Ming. And it's just something we do because she's so tall.
Stretch Ma.
Sean. Sean, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, buddies. How you doing?
Good.
Okay, mine are Mama and Papu. Papu's not around anymore, but it's still Mama, and I'm 29.
Mama and Papu. What did you grow up, Apache?
I have no idea. They're white-bred Texans, and it was Mama and Papu. And then somewhere along the family, I think it's the great-grandparents, were Meemaw and Popo or something like that.
It's just crazy talk with some of these families.
Oh, yeah. Thanks.
Just insane.
Oh, we had an aunt and uncle. Mm-hmm. You won't believe these names. Mm. We had Mommy Mole and Daddy Wee Wee.
Alright.
We're the aunt and uncle.
Alright, let me go to Chris first. Chris, you're on Run Fez. What do you got?
Yo, what's going on, fellas? How you doing?
Good.
Yo, I call my grandma Babshi. It means grandma in Polish.
Is that what that is? It's a Polish thing? Let me try to think of the family. I thought they were Italian, but it could have been Polish.
No, we're a bunch of Polacks. Call my grandma Babshi.
Oh, no, what's that? Babshi?
Yep, B-A-B-C-I.
Okay, this one I thought was a bocce.
Like bocce ball.
Yeah, that's the way I took it, but I could have had it wrong.
Or hibachi.
All right, what were these relatives of yours gone?
The aunt and uncle, Mommy Mole, and Daddy Wee Wee.
Now, why would somebody be a Daddy Wee Wee? It had to do with a dick?
No, it was actually, his name was Wynn.
Yeah.
His first name was Wynn, W-Y-N-N.
Yeah.
And, like, one of the kids couldn't say Wynn and came out Wee Wee.
You know what?
And it stuck. Same with Mole, because her name was Margaret.
I'll hold a goddamn knife up to that kid's name till he learns how to say Wynn properly before he starts calling me Wee Wee, because that ain't going to happen.
But what I didn't understand is why they weren't aunt and uncle, why they were mommy and daddy.
It's drunkenness.
It's just insane. He ended up in a tractor accident.
Why am I not shocked? Hey, Rob, you're on Ron Fez.
Hey, dudes. I have a yaya for the Greeks. Yaya.
I like that for the whole get your yayas out. I think it's, a decent way to go about it.
I didn't mean it. I didn't know it meant get your grandparents out.
Yes. That was the Rolling Stones with their big live album, Get the Yayas Out. Very, very big. Jake, you're on Ron Fez.
Yeah.
Yeah.
With my grandparents, I still call my dad's parents Mama and Papa.
Yeah.
And with my mother's parents who are now passed away, I used to call them Nanny and Grandpa. And then my great-grandparents, who are also still alive in Florida, it's like Grandpa Steve and Grandma Lola. So as it gets older, it's still not as formal. But I don't know how any of these names came around.
Yeah, it's just really odd. I guess it's up to whatever you want to be called.
My grandmother, our one Nana, when we were kids, she eventually, when we got older, she became Grandma. Because we just took it upon ourselves, we can't say Nana anymore. Yeah. It sounds crazy.
Really?
Yeah, so we decided, me and my sister, kept calling her Grandma until it caught on with everybody.
One of my grandmothers, we used to call her Sarge because she was so bossy and pushy. And she hated that because it rhymed with Marge. She was Mama Margie. And then we just broke it down to Sarge, listen, you got to stop all the screaming.
That's really cute, though.
Stop calling me Sarge. I got money missing. Here's Mark. Mark, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ronnie. How busy?
Hey, buddy.
I got a great... Well, I got three names, actually.
Go ahead.
My great-grandmother was called Grandma Duck. My
Why?
Grandma, well, she was...
Web-footed.
She lived in an old country house.
Yeah.
She always wore her hair up.
Oh, like ducks always, do.
And she always wore an apron, the old-timey apron. So she kind of looked like Mother Goose, kind of. But her name was Grandma Duck.
Grandma Duck. That's despicable. It's weird. Here's Chris. Chris, you're on Running Fez.
Hey, buddy.
Yeah.
Hey, I got a grandfather. His name's Cuckoo.
Why?
That sounds like what your parents make you call your ass.
I wasn't allowed to call him that.
I don't like. I would never have a kid. I would never make up Cooley or any of those kinds of names.
We had Toopy.
Yeah.
Because you used it to pee.
Oh, that was...
That was our dicks.
I think a better thing is to teach a little kid, this is your cock. Now, your cock is right above your balls. So you're not going to call it a toopy because, it's, you know, just so you have figured it out, Fez, you can do other things with that.
Yeah,
just
well,
so you know now.
Also, you know, no one else in the at school or anything ever knew that word.
Yeah.
Made no sense whatsoever.
I hurt my toopy. Shut up.
What?
Just makes it worse. Hey, Scott, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, buddy.
Hey, I don't know where it started. I think I just came home one day and started calling my dad Skillet, just saying, hey, what's up, Skillet? But it's stuck, and he is Skillet, and now I have a son, and he is Skillet. My son called him Skillet, too, so it's Skillet and Mimi.
Skillet is hysterical, man. Now, is he a cook?
No, it just, I think it was just like one of those things. I came home from high school one day, and instead of saying, what's up, Dad, I just said, what's up, Skillet?
What do you say, Skillet?
Yeah, what's up, Skillet?
You come home trying to be a smartass, and it sticks.
That's exactly right, man.
Skillet is actually a pretty cool name. It just seems like Cookie. It's just very comfortable. Well, that's old Skillet. Don't mind him. That's just old Skillet. He's in the back.
What's for breakfast, Skillet?
Oh, damn, them kids always want breakfast. They always come in here, Skillet. Skillet, do another one cooking breakfast for everybody.
Now, I know a man named Skillet. He made the best omelets.
Barney, you're on Ron and Fez.
Buddies.
Hey, buddy.
My friend has a couple of kids, and his wife's family's from Switzerland, and they call their grandparents Gross Mama and Gross Papa.
Yeah, they are fucking gross over there.
They'll
try to teabag the children if you're not aware, so they are gross grandparents.
It's always Hansel and Gretel.
Thank you. Hey, here's Pat from Boston. Pat, you're on Ron and Fez. Buddy.
Hi, buddy.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, we're the only ones that do it on my dad's side of the family, but it's me, my brother, and my sister, and we called my grandmother Mungie.
Mungie?
I don't know where. Yeah.
It's awful.
Sounds like a monkey's name.
Yeah.
But now all I call my son is Body.
Body.
Bye.
Hi, Body.
Body.
Hi, Body. I'm going over to my Body's house.
That's a baby Body.
Maybe that's what I make my grandkids call me Body Body. Hey, call me Body, little Body.
I go with Skillet.
That's old Skillet. Well, it seemed that after the winter was over and the spring started, Skillet found himself a big old pole, and he was going to go after that catfish. It's stupid.
Skillet, what are we having for breakfast? You don't catch that catfish yet?
Oh, that's Skillet's sidekick, Slappy Pants.
Slappy Pants is hungry. You've been trying to catch that catfish all day, Skillet. We're never going to eat.
It sounds like some stupid sidekick of John Wayne's. Remember, they would always... John Wayne would always have the least hip friend that he could ever find.
Mr. Haney was always someone's sidekick at one of those old cowboys.
Yeah, well...
They like that.
Yeah, there was another guy that looked like Mr. Haney, who was Slim Pickens, who was big, fat guy. Looked just like Mr. Haney, but it wasn't him. And he was always like, I'm trying to rustle something up!
It was always an emergency those guys.
And they always worried about the food and coffee and whatever shit that didn't matter.
I gotta find the sheriff!
And not one of them used a pistol. Every one of them had a shotgun. Like, well, you'll be able to knock something down with this. Bill, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hello?
Billy.
Yeah. My grandmother from Germany and went to Wellesley, and she always wanted to be called Grandma Jane so she wouldn't be confused with my maternal grandmother, who was part Polish.
Grandma Jane from Germany?
Yeah.
This is my grandmother, Himmler. My grandfather, the Desert Fox, is coming over this year.
Grandmama Brom.
I used to have friends that used to go back to, like, Germany to see their people. Like, they would go there for, like, a month or so. Like, you ever had to go stay any time with your grandparents?
Oh, yeah.
Well, this guy would, and remember how weird that was.
Just awful.
Yeah. And this guy would go back in to Germany. And that had to be extra weird. But I remember when I stayed with my grandparents, it just felt like everything was wrong. And I couldn't imagine my parents living with them as little kids.
My grandparents slept in separate rooms. So if we...
Separate bedroom, separate bath. Separate bedroom, separate bath.
So if we had to stay the night over there, we would all get put in Grandma's bed, and she went and slept in the garage. Yeah. Heaven forbid she climbed in with Grandpa.
Ugh. Disgusting.
And he wouldn't give it up his bed.
She'd be too close to his toupee.
Toupee. I can't believe I'm saying that on the air.
Look, fatty pneumonia, there's nothing that's left that you can feel embarrassed about. My toupee hurts.
It just sounds weird to hear it out loud.
Fez, your grandfather is on the phone right now, wants to talk to you. Hi, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Hey, how are you?
This is your friend Superstar.
Oh, Superstar.
Hi, Superstar.
How you doing, buddy? What have you been up to, Superstar?
Keeping busy and stuff. Yeah. Going, hanging out with people.
What kind of people are you hanging out with? Any girls?
Oh, different girls, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You're doing well?
Yes.
Huh?
Doing great.
All right.
The girls love Superstar.
They do.
Because he's nice.
Yes, I am.
He's good.
Yes, I am.
And bad kids?
No good.
No good.
No good.
Yeah.
Skinny kids? Good.
Good.
Babies? Good.
Good.
Beating babies? No good.
No good. That's
no good.
True. That's no good.
Yep. Walking dogs, good.
Good, yeah, good. Walking dogs is good.
Putting dogs in a kettle, no good.
No good, not in a kettle, Fezzy.
No.
Kennel, good, yeah.
But you don't want to make dog tea.
No.
No.
No good.
No good.
No good.
Yep.
No good.
Good. Yep. No yeah. good.
No good at all.
Yeah. Kicking a football.
Good.
Kicking a baby.
No good.
Why?
Because you can't kick a baby.
Sure you can, right in the soft part.
No, you can't.
Why?
Because then the baby cries.
Oh, yeah, that is true. They will start crying.
Yes, they will.
Taking a baby to the park.
Good.
Taking a baby to the park and forgetting her there and leaving her out in the cold all night.
No good.
Why is that?
You can get cold and then get pneumonia.
That's true. And fatty pneumonia junior.
I should know that better than anyone.
Yes, you
should, Ben. Eating a big bowl of spaghetti.
Good.
Eating a big bowl of baby parts.
No good.
Why?
Because you can't have baby parts to eat.
Oh, yeah. I didn't think of that.
Giving a baby a balloon.
Good.
Popping that balloon right next to the baby's eardrum so it shatters.
No good.
That's no good?
No. Good?
Oh. No, because the baby can go deaf.
Oh, that's right. The baby will go deaf.
I was so confused. They both involved a balloon. I assume both good.
No, don't assume. What happens when you assume, Fez?
Things happen bad sometimes.
Things happen bad sometimes when you assume.
That's true. That's the old saying.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, buddy. We'll talk to you soon.
Okay.
All right.
Bye.
All right. Bye-bye.
Bye, Superstar.
Bye, Ron and Fez.
All right. See you later.
See you later.
That's our good buddy, Fezzy.
That's him.
You know what? I mean, like, you know, friends come and go. That Superstar stays with us.
Oh, yeah. We'll have him the rest of our lives.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I know. That's the problem. Rest of our lives, we got to worry about him. And then I don't know what's going to happen when we die.
No good.
I don't know what they're going to do with him. Ooh.
Hmm.
I wouldn't even mind.
Scary. Scary to think about.
Put him down and he goes with us. I know it seems bad to say, but putting him down might be the best thing you could do.
Well, if you asked him.
Mm.
Good.
Good. Sure.
Eternity with Ron and Fez?
Good.
Good.
Yeah. And the chicks.
He's doing good.
He loves the ladies. He loves the ladies. Where's my man Paulie? He's the only intern I can stand anymore. I'm thinking fried egg sandwich, Paulie. I don't know where we're going with this, but it's in the back of my mind.
That's a good thought.
Send Paulie into me. Come on in here, Paulie. I like he's dressed like the third barber, Fezzy.
Oh, yeah, he's got his Tiki Barber jersey on.
And he looks exactly like him.
Yeah, Tiki, look, Rondé, and the third triplet here.
Hey, look who's on the bandwagon. The kid from Long Island, he's taking off his jet stuff, and he's starting to dress up as a Giant.
I don't like Long Island. I don't like the Islanders. I don't like the Mets. I don't like the
Where are you
Jets.
From?
Long Island. But
Why
I
do you turn on yourself?
But I wasn't born in Long Island.
Where are you born?
I was born in Queens, which is kind of, you know, Long Island near.
Long Island near.
But, like, you know, I grew up listening to a certain radio, talk radio station, and all they broadcast were the Giants, the Rangers, and the Knicks. So they became my
friends. You know what? We had a thing when I was a kid. It was called television. You ever get a chance to take a look at it?
I didn't have much money, so I didn't have cable growing up.
This is Fatty Pneumonia North.
Yeah.
So I was, you know, basically stuck on the radio. That's and they were the team's broadcast. So,
and you know what? He grew up listening to the radio, and now he's growing old being in one, Fezzy. It's just amazing for him.
You're coming full circle.
Well, anyway, I called you in here not to hear of your bio, but I was thinking of a fried egg sandwich. What are we thinking about? You got something local?
You could go to...
No, I won't be going. You'll
be going. Rock and Roll Deli.
Oh. You sure? Do you like this?
I haven't eaten a sandwich from there, but I've gotten other people and they haven't complained.
Not complaining is not what I'm looking for, Paulie. I know you listening to the radio is a tot out there in near Long Island. It must have occurred to you that food's important to keep this whole game going, right?
Yeah.
So Rock and Roll Deli, that's your...
Rock and Roll Deli, I could...
It's just, they don't seem like they're taking it very serious with that name to me, Fez. I don't feel like they know what they want to do.
Yeah, where it's they're more interested in the music than the sandwiches.
You want anything to eat, Fez?
Yeah, I'll get one of those fried egg sandwiches. That sounds good.
What comes with it, though? Like, what's on the side?
What are you thinking, Pauly?
I don't know. They have...
Because I got to tell you, Pauly, I'm starving.
I know you like men's meals. You like meat on your, you know,
yeah, I like
pizza,
a men's
stuff
meal.
Like
yeah,
that.
I like a men's meal.
How do you handle a hungry man? The man handler.
I never thought of that, but I do. I eat men food.
Well, I was told.
What do you want me to do? Eat a salad? Is that what you're
No, I was going to recommend they have
maybe
fruit.
You want
to
go
a nice
baby
fruit
source.
Salad.
Huh? A fruit salad?
Yeah.
You know what? Maybe one day I'll turn gay, start sucking cock, and eating fruit salad. I don't see it happening. Fez, I got this for you.
Doesn't work that way.
I'm going to buy you a men's meal. Fez, you're with me. All right?
Thank you.
And you know what? Who I wish was here is my best friend right now, Dr. Steve from Tennessee. I just want to thank him for these cigars.
It's again?
A lovely gesture. He's keeping them coming. I guess that's the last thing I'll ever get from him, though. I don't see me getting any more.
Seems to keep the supply line to you open. Mm.
Whatever. You know what to do?
What?
Like the red states and blue states, let's stay separate. So we're thinking men's food for me, huh?
Yeah, I'm thinking a man's meal.
You know what?
A man's meal.
You know what? You'd look good in a man's meal.
So, man's meal, huh?
Yeah, man's meal.
Because, you know, the...
Good idea, Skillet.
You know, I know... I know you're thinking dried fruit or whatever, but that ain't going to work for me. That ain't gonna happen. All right, Skillet, here's the thing. You're going to get us a couple egg sandwich, fried egg sandwiches.
Okay. Would you like that on bread or a roll?
You know what I like? I like it on toasted rye bread today.
Okay.
Fez, what about you?
Toasted white bread.
Okay.
That could be your nickname, Toasted White Bread. What do you want to drink, Fuzzy?
Any sort
Jaeger?
Of... Ooh, no.
Keep it going with some Jaeger?
Any sort of black cherry soda dealio going on, like a Dr. Brown's or something.
They got Dr. Brown's there?
I'll try. I don't know. I'll look.
I'm saying yes from... so I'm going to go in that direction, too.
Okay.
And you know what, for me? Throw in a bag of regular chips.
Okay.
Double that down.
All right.
But, Fez, you know, when I say I'm buying, I didn't think I was buying four courses. I don't know what's wrong with that water. You can't drink water?
Not with chips and egg sandwiches, no. That's gross.
Just ask him if it costs anything extra to toast it. And if it does, just throw him regular white bread. And I'll hit it with a lighter over here. I'll run a lighter under the bottom of it.
It turns the bread too black.
Would you like ketchup or anything on it? Or
no, that's
like
extra.
That?
What I don't want, Fezzy, is you to be running up this tab acting like there's no worries. You're living right now like you're one of the Rockefellers.
It's basically my wish list.
You know what? I'm not even all that hungry. Whatever I don't eat, you just eat some of mine. So just give him one thing of bread, and I'm going to give him most of my runoff, my egg runoff.
That's just the egg parts that fall off and hit the paper.
That's fucking plenty good. It's protein, which you need.
When you bite into the sandwich.
You wouldn't even have thought of eating unless I brought it up. You're fine with this. All right, and you know what? I'm gonna.
Doesn't sound like I'm getting much of a man's meal.
You got two starving men here today, all right? I haven't eaten in like 2.5 hours.
Men raised by men.
Yeah. Ooh. Well, Fez was raised 6 inches by a man.
My feet are kicking.
He claims more, but I don't think so. All right, you ready, big dog?
I'm ready.
All right. You got to run like one of the Barber twins, all right? You're the Barber triplet right now.
All
right.
Run like Tiki. Although Rondé does all right.
Don't kid yourself. Rondé does okay.
You got a ring.
True.
Mm, ring to it. Sean Thornton. Let's take a break. And when you come back, you might be able to hear us eating a fried egg sandwich. It's the Ron and Fez Show.
Ronnie B. SW. Ron and Fez. It's the best of Ron and Fez on XM 202.
Ron and Fez.
Anthony's sitting in with us.
Appreciate it, Ant.
We got all these drunk chicks looting Martian.
Chicks?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I misunderstood for a
second. Come on, you know you like her a little bit. You missed it when she was in here with her pants down getting spanked by the other girls.
I got caught up in a foosball game out there. It was hot and heavy, and I figured it was sexier than coming in here and watching.
It was.
But her ass got bit twice.
All right, a guy just showed up. Who's here, Roy?
Rory, come on over to the mic. Who's the guy who showed up?
We have a guy named Rick.
Yeah.
All right.
He showed up. He's blind.
What did he want to do?
He just wanted to come in and hang out and meet.
I thought he wanted to. Yeah, oh, he wanted to meet the girls.
Yeah, he wanted to meet all the girls and stuff.
He has trouble meeting girls.
All right, bring him in.
Okay.
It's not Jose Feliciano blind.
I hope.
It's like weird.
What? All right,
no
hold on.
Glasses
what?
Blind.
Why not have glasses?
I know. That's what I say.
Oh, so it's like a real,
it's
an
like
actual eye deformity.
Really hard to look at. Yeah.
All right.
Here comes Rory.
Just making sure. All right, who you got here, Rory?
This is Rick.
Rick, how are you, pal?
Buddy.
Nice to see you, buddy.
Buddy. Rick, what's welcome to the Ron and Fez Show.
Now, Rick, you're 100% blind?
Oh.
Oh, my God, they're fake. He just tapped
Who's
his eyeballs.
Who's the chick?
He heard a check.
Where is she?
No. Now, who brought you in here? Who's this with you?
It's my buddy Jack.
He's your buddy Jack. Because you guys have the same look. I thought maybe it was family. Now, we need a little Stevie Wonder for him. Now, let me ask you this, Rick. What happened with the eyes to begin with?
Where are you, Ron?
I'm over there to the left. Yeah.
See, the headphones, you got to explain this to the other people.
Oh.
When you have the headphones on, you know, with the blind. Oh, there's Stevie.
Yeah.
Look out. Look out. When you get the headphones on, the blind guys don't know where you are. See, we have to focus on a voice, so I can't have them look to the left. You don't care about that.
No, I had no idea. It never once
occurred
to me.
You, right?
Yeah.
When we get the headphones on, we're all out. We're just totally out.
All right, Rick, were you born blind?
I wasn't. I had tumors when I was 18.
18
months, sorry.
Oh, 18 months.
Oh, 18 months old.
So do you remember seeing it all?
I really don't. But yeah. I have two questions for you.
Yeah.
Which is kind of the reason. I got to touch Fez's head before I leave.
Yeah, you're going to be able to do that.
That's one thing. And why do the blind guys that call in sound like retards when they call in?
I always thought that there was something tied in between blind guys
that
and retards.
The blind guys always sound like this when they call in. And I always wanted.
So you're saying there's no connection.
I wanted to know why that's the.
There's no connection.
Why that's the case all the time.
That was Martian you heard.
Right.
Oh, see, I shouldn't have said that.
2020 vision.
Now, who says that, Anthony?
But we'll stand in the rain.
Yes, it's Anthony.
Very good.
Oh, he's somewhere. He's somewhere.
You got to find him.
Anthony? Where are you?
Here.
Speak.
No.
Oh.
No, I'm not going to talk.
No, see,
Marco.
This is a bad scene.
Marco. All right, try to guess who this is. Ready?
We're going on a vacation.
Yeah. That scared me.
Yeah.
Now, the two-hour Spanish cab ride that I had was nice, too.
Where'd you come in from?
I came in from Queens. I got in the cab. He said, first I get into the cab. The Tito Puente music is blasting out of the cab.
Yeah.
Let it go. So I have to say, I have to say I'm going, you know, can I say the street? Or we don't.
Yeah, go, no, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, you know, I'm,
you
I'm,
got here. What else could weird us out
I'm
tonight?
I'm in the 50s, right? So I'm going. We're going down to the 50s. He's going, he's got the Spanish music going. Of course, I can't hear the show because we're blasting in the cab. I get the Spanish music blasting. I can't hear anything. The guy, when we get to 50th Street, goes, 777-5515. And I said, what? And he goes, 777-5515. And I said, no. So we went 888. 777-5515. Pulls over. I swear to God. Another cab. And then he goes, we're here.
You know, I heard when you're blind, your other senses get better. The sense of good radio is not one of those senses.
You don't like that, right?
I have noticed. Because the sense of smell, right, and hearing gets better.
Anthony,
but for some reason, that sense...
Ready digging in.
I'm just teasing with you, my friend.
So that's a Braille watch you got on?
It is.
You were interested in meeting a chick?
Boy, I go, you know, go old roots. I thought you guys might want to do before you left a little jamming. There was another guy out there with a guitar, so I bought the cool guitar.
I'm sorry you had to hear that.
Yeah, you don't need that.
Yeah, no, we might jam a little later.
And this guitar, Ron, by the way, is a flag.
No, I'm on the other side. I'm to the radio.
You're lying to me. All right. Speak up. See, this doesn't make for good radio. They don't like that. They don't. The looking left and right, they don't care.
Hey, at least it's not Rutger Hauer.
There you go.
All right?
I didn't hear that, you know. I heard about it, but I didn't actually hear it. We got to do that on the best of, right? But I do have a flag. The guitar is shaped like a flag. It's got a little preamp in it, the whole thing. There's another guy out there with an acoustic. Stevie's gone. Though this bit's going to hell right now. Silent tree. So this is the blind hour of silent treatment. Wow. Okay, the square. We got a squeaking chair. How about a blind view of what's happening in the room? We got a squeaking chair to the left. To the right, we got a fan. And as Stevie gets lower, got the squeaky chair to the left. To the right, we got the fan. So it's my show. Taking phone calls. Where's the phone calls? Come on, pop them down. This is a bad scene. I don't want to go back into the cab ride because I didn't finish the story. I sound good in the headphones, though. I'll give you that. Squeaking chair to the left. There's also a girl to the left. I can tell you that. And the place stinks of Lysol. I can tell you that. Straight off. As soon as you walk in, Lysol. That is heavy Lysol. And I didn't bring my handy wipes to touch Fez's head because I figured he might be a little germophobic. But you got to admit, it's pretty good how I'm going on with this little bit. And the best part of it is it's live in New York. Oh, there you go. You know, speaking of urine. There's a big party outside. Me and my buddy Jack walk in. Jack says there's a lot of girls. I said, anybody stripping? He says no. I don't get the urine reference, though. I'm not following that one. Oh, this is a bad scene. Guys are killing. Killing. I don't want to be whipping the guitar out because you might think it's a machine gun in here. Which it's not. We could figure out words. Take it what? Take it out. I gotta take it out. There's a bunch of CDs that are gonna fall out. Check that out. I know somebody's to the left. The flag. It's got its own preamp in it. Anthony will, being a musical connoisseur, you'll get a kick out of that. Oh, God almighty. And we were not allowed to tune, of course, in the green room. Now, I have heard Blind Dave on before, and I have to say Blind Dave on ONA's show does not sound like a retard. And why don't we have Neumann mics in here? I'd love to do a sing-along. But nobody will sing with me. Jesus. Well, hey, out through my brain, anything that don't seem the same. back to front, but I don't know why. Skew me while I kiss the sky. That's enough of that. Not bad. Not bad.
Oh, thank you, guys. Thank you.
Very good, Rick.
That made
nice work, Rick.
That made me feel good.
That we just came great. Back in.
What happened?
We had to all leave for a second. What happened?
That made me feel good.
We had to leave during the commercials. What were you doing in here?
Well, I was listening to urine
what
samples.
What are you doing talking to yourself during the commercials?
I got the urine samples. I got the chair squeaking on the other side. And I came in as a goof and I bought the guitar. I wasn't going to bring the guitar.
No, man. Sounds good.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Will you sing with me, Ron?
Yeah, sure. What do you want to do?
Anything you want. You name a song.
Oh, I don't know a lot of blind songs, so...
Oh, come on. Hendrix wasn't a blind
guy. All I know is that Feliz Navidad.
Oh, that's a good one.
That one I can't help.
Yeah.
Oh.
I get sorry.
What's the chances?
I'm glad you're talking to me now. You know, the most uncomfortable feeling for a blind guy has got to be to be in a big room with a fan on.
You know,
chair squeaking.
You know what kills
and
me?
And not knowing where anybody is. But I got through it.
Anthony, did you ever know that there was that fan in this room making any noise at all?
I had
all
no
the time
clue.
We worked here.
I've never heard the fan.
We take it for granted.
Yes,
is
we
what
take
it
fans
is.
For granted.
And speaking, you take speaking for granted as well, it seems.
Anthony, nah, bro, you came through flying colors.
I did all right, right?
Yeah.
I mean, you know, how long was that? What'd we go for?
It was only about 30 seconds.
Yeah.
I don't know what that is in blind years, man, seconds, but you're great.
You know, to the blind dogs, that's got to seem like 7 years, right?
Right.
Anthony won't sing with me. How about we take it out later on, you know? Like, before the show ends, we do a little sing-along, we get some of the girls.
What kind of, you know, yeah, we'll bring in the chicks.
How do you like the color of the flag? Can we explain to
that's a black guitar,
that's a black guitar.
By the way.
Someone I don't know what
lying.
They told you our flag looks
yeah,
like.
Right.
You know, I'm hearing that it's supposed to be a flag.
It's the Iraqi like, flag. You must get a lot
you
of
son of a bitch.
Of crap for that.
And it's small, right? If we explain to the audience, it's a small little tiny guitar that's got a little flag on it. It's very patriotic. I figure the American thing, 4th of July, before we get blown up, you know, the whole thing.
It's nice. Very nice guitar. Where'd you get it from?
I ordered it online. You know,
now, how would you online? Order it, anything online?
I am a recording engineer.
Yeah.
I have a recording studio because I think that's all blind people do.
Right.
Get into music and
they're
have
big into sound.
They love the sound. They have the recording studios. Every blind guy that calls up's got a recording studio.
You never meet a blind magician.
You don't meet a blind car racer either. When do you see Mario and
Drew?
True. Yeah.
Right.
And I thought that would be a good bit for O&A's show. A little blind car racing.
Can you drive? Have you driven before?
I have driven. I've driven in Canada.
Oh,
where
yeah.
It's legal.
You know what I'd like to do?
Canada.
Let's have Rick drive in a race car.
I do it.
You can drive for the O&A show, and then me and Fez will train two monkeys, one to work the steering wheel, the other works the gas and brake, and we'll see who
wins. Gets there first,
yeah.
Right?
No parallel parking.
You give me
just a straight out dead race.
You give me a nice clear pass, I'm good to go.
You got a check in your life?
Yeah, here and there, you know. I get a little something every now.
Good.
You know, I hear laughing over there. Was that not sweet Melissa over there?
Yeah!
Wow, you picked
good.
Her out.
Melissa, you are
hi.
Good.
There she is.
Hi, Rick.
Hey, baby.
It's
how
great
are
to
you?
Meet you?
And it was very painful for Melissa to give you the silent treatment. She didn't want to at all. We just had to keep putting our hand up to her
Melissa's
face.
Melissa's got to give me a great big hug.
All right, go ahead, Melissa.
Oh, now?
Yeah.
I thought before. Oh,
no,
sweet.
There you go.
Oh, that's nice.
Right, look, he's just going for a cheap feel. The blind is so cruel that way.
She's not in Braille. I'll quit reading her.
What did she smell like?
She smells good.
Yeah.
You got a little something over there, right? You're not catching that over there?
I have no sense of smell. My sight is perfect.
You get the sight, you don't get the smell.
So my sight is so good, it actually ruins my other senses.
Now, the website thing, by the way, since you asked me how I ordered this online,
well,
you got the talking, you know, the whole thing. You got the talking computers, you got the talking this, the talking Pro Tools, the talking that. It's everything talks.
And it tells you ordered a flag guitar?
No, you got to be a genius.
You ordered red, white, and blue.
I wanted a flag guitar. Initial.
Damn this computer.
I went with a fag guitar, but I got the flag guitar. That's a whole subject. You know, we don't want to spend a boring hour of talking. You know.
Rick, what kind of music you normally do?
I do, a little this, a little that. The Sykes CD that I handed to somebody, whoever that was, is kind of a rock.
You handed that to a Puerto Rican kid who ran running.
I gave it to the cab driver.
It was a bagel, not a CD.
All right, this, I guess, is called the Black Album because there's nothing on
the
it.
The cab
Come
driver
on.
Got that one, right?
All right, now everybody in the band is blind?
Oh, Jesus Christ. Can you imagine that? Tripping all over everybody and all kinds of craziness would go on with that. No, just me.
Oh.
Just me. We got a tremendous drummer. We got a...
you know, great bassist.
You know, usually when they put bands together, they try to find, you know, the cute one, the
right.
funny one, the
what
smart
do you think,
one.
Where do I fit
the blind one.
That's me.
Why
right?
not do the blind one, the deaf one, the... I don't know what else.
I didn't think blind...
Asthmatic?
No, a guy with flippers for hands. And off we go.
I didn't think blind psych would be a good name.
All right, here's Tenacious C. She wants to give you a hug, too, and you can check out her smell. We can bring all the broads in to give them...
Can we do that?
Yeah. Just get them in a pile.
Oh, sweetheart.
All right.
Damn.
Ronnie.
Look at this. But she's got the long hair.
Oh.
Rick, do you think that if we brought in, like, a few girls...
we're going to play a game.
And
yeah.
We told you their name, and you got to smell them as you hugged them. We could bring them back, and you could tell us what order they were in.
Oh, I love that.
A game.
Yeah.
I don't think I can.
No. Come on.
Oh, okay.
Now listen. There are blind people, I'm sure, that can do that.
Why can't you do it?
Let me try. Let me just go for two or three.
Let's try it.
Yeah, right.
Two or three.
All right, let's bring in three.
No hands on the edge right
yeah.
now. Right?
Make sure Mosh is one.
Cause, oh, please.
Yeah.
Come on. Don't
right.
go
Did
there.
Did you hear that, Rory?
Don't go there with me.
Ronnie, yeah, go ahead.
If I can go hands on the ass,
yeah.
I'll know straight like that.
All right.
Braille ass.
If I can go hands on the ass, I would know who's who. But, you know, we got to have them agree.
No.
We got to have the... Yes.
What are they going to do? So a blind guy? What are they going to do? You're fine.
Not going to punch me in the face, right?
All right.
You won't see it coming.
Thank you.
You ever been in a fight before?
You know, I listened to the blind boxing thing.
Yeah.
And you know, I'm not the type to call in and try to get into all this because it's the first time I've done it. And I heard it. I said, Jesus, I could never do that because that would be a mess.
Yeah.
That would
You're just not a fighter.
Anthony, what did those guys look like?
They were blind.
Right.
Yeah.
Were they big?
Yeah, a couple of them. Big guys.
The Dave sounded like a big dude.
No, he's just drunk all the time.
He's just drunk.
So he doesn't care. He'll swing at anything.
just right in the air.
Well, yeah.
Right in the air. And when they were boxing each other, did they go for the face?
See,
if I was doing the blind boxing thing, I would always be punching midair, you know? Because if you get high, you figure
out. Oh, wait, here's the important thing, the girls.
All right.
That's all I came for.
First, we'll let you. Here comes Nurse Myra. You can take a nice big smell of her. Go ahead in there, Nurse Myra.
Which side you coming in? Hey, baby.
Yeah.
I like that.
Oh, he likes that. Yeah. Look at that sense of feel. Gets so acute.
Yeah.
She's got a nice grip, too. She's got the grip on you. Now, Nurse Myra's got to be out, though, right off the bat, because I can tell right by her hair.
Oh, is that right?
See, so I don't know if I should disqualify myself for this.
We don't know.
You could tell by her hair because she's. You know what I'm saying?
But you were touching her lap.
You know, I'm going.
Yeah.
That's
bad.
Let's try another
one.
Let's go for two.
All right. Let's go. Here comes Annie the Flasher. Annie, come on up.
Don't leave me though, baby.
Yeah. Right,
number two is Annie.
You're coming up. Oh, Annie. Oh, you know I got to do this every week. Can I be a regular here?
Yeah.
I got to be here on the Friday. Annie. Yeah.
He's starting to see shapes and colors.
Wait a minute.
This is
all
in talk.
Coming back.
She's a you're Flasher.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
If you flash me, what would happen?
Flash the blinds. Let's see if we can make him see.
If you flash me, let me see what would happen.
Yeah.
God, I can see!
Oh, my.
Jesus Christ! She's done it!
Wow, it's that whole if a tree falls in the woods.
You're not blind at all. How would you know exactly when she pulled her tees out?
This is another little blind thing. I had my hand right on the top, and as soon as
it came down.
She felt the motion.
You like the way I did that, though, right?
Yeah, it's good.
I fooled you with that one.
All right, and here comes Clarice. Come on up, Clarice.
Is this Crazy Claire?
No, this is another. This is a new girl, new friend of ours, Clarice.
Yeah.
Are you a knife cutter? You're not a knife cutter, right?
No.
All right. I'm with it. Now, I can definitely tell you.
Like some bonga.
Where was the, ooh, yeah.
Yeah.
Clarice is a beautiful woman.
Yeah.
She's the Zoftic type, you would have to say. Was that a good description for you? You don't like Zoftic. This one's cool.
You're digging him, Mosh? I mean, Clarice?
She's going.
What? Yeah. She won't let go of him.
She's trying harder.
Help!
Wasn't that a Big Bang clap that was in? Oh,
what's my face?
Oh, now I know. Now I know.
You're a sweetheart.
Mosh, I mean, Clarice, what do you think of him? Would you dig a blind guy? Could you see yourself in that relationship?
Speak over here, sweet.
No.
See, I'm giving
the blind guy had to point out the mic.
Jesus. Yeah. What? If he was what?
If he treats me right, yeah.
If I treat her right. What about the hair? You like the hair? A lot of chicks don't dig the long hair anymore.
Oh, is that right?
They really, you know, they're knocking me out lately. Ron Fez, 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, it was girl after girl after girl. Since the hair's been growing.
Yeah.
I'm out.
No, you don't think it has anything to do with the fact that you got marbles for eyes? It's more the hair.
I don't think that's what it is. How do they look, though? They look good, right?
Oh, please.
You can't even tell.
They freaked me.
But you wouldn't know.
If I didn't do that.
You wouldn't know if I didn't do that.
One's a ping pong ball.
Let's see a beat on him again. That freaked me out.
But would you know if I didn't do that?
Though? Yeah, the man. They're awful.
Oh, come on. You're lying.
Oh,
wow.
God.
That's something.
Anthony likes. I do it for Anthony.
You know what I would love to do? Look at Hawk is falling down. But if we had a crow just pecking on one of your eyes, it would be the best
thing. That'd be wild, man.
It's like the birds.
Now, Anthony, would you be able to tell that they're not real eyes?
No, not at all.
Thank you, Anthony. He's sticking up for me.
Sure.
Fez is sticking up for me, right, Fez? Cubo? Oh, sorry.
Hey. Oh, you wanted to touch my head, didn't you?
Yeah.
Oh, that's all right. I'll do it before I leave.
All right,
now let me get one of the three girls.
All right, hold on now.
You're not going to give me four, are you?
We're going to put one of the girls up to you, and we won't even know which one.
All right.
And see if you can guess
who it is. I need the names again. One was Melissa. No, Melissa was not part
God,
of this.
Your Jesus. Senses are one, all off.
Jesus. One was Clarice.
You spent your life coked up.
One was Nurse Myra. One was Clarice. And who's the other one?
The one that had the tears in your face. You don't remember.
The flasher. What was her name?
Yeah, that's good enough.
That's good enough.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. Come on back, baby. All right. Let's see what we got here. This would be this is the flasher.
Very good.
Nice.
Very nice.
You got it, right?
Good. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, do I get another one?
Go ahead, you get another one.
Because I got that one, you figure I'll just get all the rest, right?
No, that's all right.
This would be my nurse.
Yeah.
Correct.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Baby.
Good.
I like her. She's got these hands. All right.
I'm not going to put the third one.
Well, the third one we already know. Don't attack me. Wait a minute. The hell is this? It's a guy.
It's Fezzy.
That's Fez.
You're such a cool guy.
Rubbing his head.
Guys, feel the scalp.
I want to tell everybody.
He's feeling the scalp.
All the other blind people in the audience. How many teeth you got for this? Two?
How many teeth?
No, how many blind people? Two?
Two people.
Gotta be
two blind people.
There's got to be two more blind people.
All right.
He's really got no hair. I didn't believe none at all. I didn't believe he did that.
And now I'd just like to say this.
Uh-oh.
Ronnie. A blind guy touched me! A blind guy touched me!
Hey, we can do the same game. We've got enough bald guys in here now.
Do we?
All right, give me...
Fez is a bigger guy than I...
Everybody says that.
All right.
Yeah.
Sorry, Fez.
Yeah.
You're the best.
Which head were you on?
All right,
I don't know.
All right, now we're going to see your sense of touch with different bald heads, okay?
We're really making a whole bit out of this
one.
Yeah,
why not?
Jesus.
We're going to do a lot of...
I was in and out. I was in and out in like 30 seconds. All right,
no.
Especially when I get the silence.
No. You handled that. You'll be our buddy forever now.
Oh, you're the best.
Ronnie, what about Earl? Does Earl want to play?
No.
Please.
You know, I heard he's not talking.
Yeah, he's not talking.
Now, when they open that door, the audience can hear that party, huh?
Yeah, it comes right in.
Not as well as you can. All right, now, all you're allowed to touch now is the heads, okay?
Just the heads.
So the first person you're going to touch, this is Wonder Boy's head.
I don't think this is going to work.
Yeah, I'm excited about it.
You feel it's going to work.
All right.
Wonder Boy's very smooth.
Okay, he just got it shaved tonight. All right, next, stepping up is Black Girl. You'll be touching his
Black
head.
Black Girl who won't talk to me.
Right.
This one I got. I know that straight off.
All right, you're going to know that one
right
away.
I know that straight off.
It's like a coconut.
And then here comes Fez.
Fez again?
Yeah. Just the head.
Fez is very close to Black Girl's head.
Yes.
Oh, Fezzy. I'm sorry.
I didn't mean to be.
Oh.
All right, now we're going to take them back and mix them up and see if the blind guy can guess the skull.
Mixing them straight through.
And if not, we're taking one of those marbles out of your face, all right?
Hey. You know, I have to give props to your screeners, too, because I was coming down here with two girls today.
Yeah, sure you were.
Nobody calls me up. I swear to God.
Mm-hmm.
Can I say hi to them?
Yeah.
Brendan and Janet. Hey, right. Baby.
Yeah, more than the Niagara Falls area.
I was coming down with them, with the two of them.
All right, now just...
That would be Earl.
Wow!
Yes! Yes, baby!
That's good.
We better get some video of that.
And here's somebody that wants to say hi to you.
Yeah, hi. This is Rutger.
Oh, jeez.
It's Rutger.
Rutger! Oh, sorry. I thought we were still playing.
We played Blind Fury. That was his big movie. Fezzy, we got to take a break. And when we come back, we'll have like a blind jam and I'll be drunk. No, you're hanging out.
Oh, you're the best.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks.
All right.
Cool
beans. All coming up on Ron and Fez.
Have it.
The Ron and Fez Show.
Ron and Fez here. You can always email us at ronandfez@AOL.com.
ronandfez@AOL.com. For us, it's like getting the bat signal.
It's the best of Ron and Fez on XM202, The Virus.
Blind Rick is in here, Anthony is in, and they're trying to put together a song. Ant, you're going to sing a song on the air?
Yes,
nah,
he is.
We tried to get something together.
SDP.
It wasn't working. They didn't know the song, though.
All right, what's the song?
But I would have done it, but no. Nah.
But we know it now.
All right, let's try it a little bit, see if you can pick it up.
Here's your cue, baby. 2, 3, 4.
And I feel time's a waste to go. See, they don't know it. After that, it falls apart.
After that,
I had the first line.
Yeah,
that's what I was talking about.
We got it.
We were trying to work it out.
All right.
If you sing backup, Ron.
Yeah, sure. I'm here.
Get one of those three chord things together you know. That's all. They don't know the song there.
Now, do these people even know Hang on Sloopy? Do we have enough people to sing?
They're all going to know the chord.
All right, well, let's open up. Let's let everybody back in or other broads. Only the singers, and if anybody starts to yell, Rory, start to throw them out one at a time.
You got your orders, Rory.
It was like Woodstock out there. There's guitars, nude women, mud.
Right.
It was insane.
Yes. Where did the mud come from?
I don't know.
Anthony, you did a great job.
Mud.
You did a great job.
The mud. Hey, you know, Blind Rick, you really let us down with that. I thought blind people knew every song.
I started playing it. He knocked me out. He did a great job, though.
Science, I don't know if that's a blind thing. It's a blind thing. You know, hey, Jeff Healy? Can we do a little Jeff Healy?
I don't know.
I would think a blind guy would learn every blind guy's song.
Right, I would.
You know?
That's the one thing I don't know.
It's a blind cabaret.
I would feel about these guys the same way black kids used to feel about Jackie Robinson's. It's like whatever he's doing.
Right, it's your hero.
What about, Anthony, what about the other Stone Temple Pilots song?
No.
You know that one?
The song?
Yeah.
I don't remember that
one.
What album is that off of?
Right, nobody could sing?
You don't know that one.
They all said they didn't know the words to the song, so.
All right, send them all home.
Creepy song.
I did.
What song? You don't even know what song we're doing yet.
We'll do
a Hang on Sloopy.
Let's do a Hang on Sloopy.
It's like every stoned garage I've ever been in. What do? I know half of this. I know a quarter of that.
You want to hit that? GCD?
What do you want to do?
We'll do a little Hang on Sloopy. Everybody can sing.
No one knows it.
They know Hang on Sloopy. Hang on Sloopy. Sloopy, hang on. Yeah, yeah.
That's the whole thing.
Do it over and over again.
All right. Okay.
And then there's a verse that I'll do something in, and then we all come back in. How easy is that?
I have the feeling a one-eyed guy will show up and be king here in a heartbeat.
You think that's good?
Earl's here, so we could do some Living Color song.
Oh.
Right?
Yeah, that's good. What do you know, Earl, by Living
Color?
Open
letter to a landlord. What do you know?
What do you got there, Earl?
Cult of Personality.
All right, Earl's grabbing the guitar. I've never even seen him play before.
Wow.
What are we going to do, Earl?
Earl, what do you got? Earl doesn't talk too much.
Yeah. He's no picks.
Going to play it for you now. Here it goes.
That's the problem.
That's how it starts.
What do you suppose this is? Mama, take these with me. Knocking on heaven's door. Is that what he's doing?
Is that what we're doing?
Could be 20 songs.
I don't know.
Married a yuppie. Took him for all he was worth. That's what it sounds like.
What are we playing, Earl?
We've got a mute and a blind guy.
This isn't working. This is not working.
Was
out.
That supposed to be Knocking on Heaven's Door?
What is that?
Tom Petty.
Tom Petty.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, right.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
We don't know that one, though. Who knows
but that's
that?
20
Nobody
songs.
Nobody knows it, yeah.
Who knows that?
That's Earl. Every Petty song.
How about a Beatles
Anywhere
song?
Anyone town swinging.
I think everybody knows Beatles.
Yeah, what do you got by the Beatles
Whatever
there?
You need. What do you need? You tell me what you need, we got.
What do you need?
What do you need?
You do.
How about...
You lead it.
What?
Sweet Home.
The act saying Sweet Home.
Fez's national anthem.
Sweet Home Alabama. See, nobody's going to sing along.
But it don't start like that.
No, it starts
right. Maybe it does in Blind Town, but...
You can't just come in the middle of a song.
Why can't we come in on a chorus?
Is there a Blind Town?
Why can't we come
in? There should be.
If there is, I ain't going. I'd be so weirded out.
The traffic's awful there.
And you can't find Visine.
Yeah. No eye drops for that. Yeah. Let's do Hang on.
It's a Windex.
Yeah, right. This says Windexing.
GCD.
GCD. Here we go. We're all going to sing GCD.
Hang on, super GCD. Hang on. Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Hang on, super. Super. Hang on.
Yeah. Yeah. There's supposed to be some jazz with Peter. Snoopy in a very bad part of town. Now we need to ooh.
It's not 1964.
Try to put my Snoopy down.
You know anything newer?
No, I just figured we all sing along in the chorus. And we'll do it again. Ready?
No, it ain't.
No, no, no.
You don't like it.
No. Earl was ready to rock.
Yeah, Earl's ready to rock.
I'm feeling Earl over here.
Yeah, Earl, what's happening? Where are we going?
Something from the Black Rock Coalition, Earl.
Oh, Hendrix, come on, baby.
Hendrix, what are you...
When Cries Mary, hit it.
When Cries Mary.
When Cries Mary? That'll take the whole show.
Oh, look
hole.
Who's here.
Bon Jovi fan
drunk.
Since day one. Bon Jovi fan since day one. Highly newly bald Fez.
Do you,
I always forget who hasn't seen it.
Eddie, do you sing any songs? You know any tunes you want to sing along with?
I would never subject you guys to that. What do you got, Earl? What do you got?
What do you got, Earl?
A little Slayer for me or Motorhead?
Did I start this what do you need, what do you got thing over here?
Yeah,
what
it's all happening.
What do you got? What do you, know? What do you need? What do you got? Everybody's on this.
Give us a sample of the Black Rock Coalition.
You guys are asking for trouble talking to Catherine Earl.
What is this now? I'm catching the chords. I don't know the song.
Some Hendrix.
Just tell us.
Tell us what it is, Earl.
Speak.
Is there any way out of here? All right, thank
there
you, Earl.
There must be some kind of way out of here. Said the Joker to the thief.
Yeah, there you go.
There's too much confusion. I can't get no relief.
And then Earl takes over. Go ahead, Earl.
All right. I'll stop.
Yeah, that's a real sing-along
Jesus.
There. Dylan meets Hendrix. That's going to have people singing on the bus trip to the zoo.
Everyone booted
Where's
heroin
Masha?
Along, though.
Right.
It was good. Everyone tied off and shot up during that song.
How about Louie wouldn't work, right?
Oh, Louie.
Who knows
back
it?
Back into the 60s because, you know.
There is no way one whole song is getting done.
Get off
no
the
way.
Braille handbook and just come up with something everybody knows. How about Sweet Child of Mine?
There you go.
Guns N' Roses.
Who's going to say? All right. How about Zeppelin?
This guy has not learned a song in 30 years.
How about a little Zeppelin? Everybody must know that. Zeppelin?
I bring Moshin back to hug him.
Oh, yeah.
No. Hear that? Now you're getting a Moshin hug.
All right, you like that?
Anthony will sing this with me.
Tell her to come
what?
Back.
I'm not you. Singing Zeppelin. Robert Plant can't sing Zeppelin.
Baby, you're not fooling. I'm going to send you back to school. Way
oh,
down
God.
Inside. Honey, you me. I'm going to give you my love. I'm gonna get a Maya! Oh! I wanna hold out of love!
Well, the girls are dancing.
I wanna hold out of love!
Yeah, right.
I wanna hold out of love!
Alright,
you
just fine.
You knocked me off. Anthony knocked me straight off.
I didn't do anything.
He didn't right. sing with me.
I said the right. girls would dance.
Rory, it's been such a long, long week. Open that door and scream, get Fez a beer.
Yeah.
Oh. There you go.
Yeah.
Alright,
and Rory.
I can't take it anymore.
How about you really got me? How
hey,
about that?
Rory,
you
when
did.
The door's open, throw the blind guy out, would you?
Oh, we were doing good. How about it? You really got me. Everybody's got to know that. That's an 80s and the 60s and the 70s. We got every.
I'd rather
decade.
Bring an organ grinder in here.
Yes, it's the best blind hits of the 60s, 70s, and today.
No, we didn't get today in there yet. We only got to 92 with the STP.
That doesn't count. It was one line. Not even a verse.
Shotgun that thing, Fez. Just bang it.
Play some Guns N' Roses.
Guns N' Roses, I don't think we're going to have a sing-along.
Oh,
I got to tell you.
Jesus. Get windy out.
Can we do a Stones tune?
You still love her. Everybody can sing that.
How about Satisfaction? Stones tune. He said Stones tune.
What year is this?
Well, we're part of the sing-along, don't we understand?
How about we pop your eyes out and shoot them like they're marbles?
Oh.
What I say?
It's an Aggie.
Oh, what I say?
If I go Come out on. And play the pinball machine and one of those things is staring at me in there, I am going to freak.
Jeff actually has a tune to do, right? You and Carter, you wanted to do one more?
Yeah,
I'll play
All right, come on.
Yeah, right. Play along with
that. Yeah, you play Rick. Along.
There you go.
Set up Carter.
And Rick, we're going
to... you have to move to a microphone, yeah. All right? We can't move the console over to you.
He's used to doing well for himself.
It's a surly drinking fest.
I know. You actually haven't been nice since Wednesday. All right, chick's making out in the corner. I always like to see that. Hey, did you see Swiss wow. Miss get naked earlier?
I did.
Taking pictures. She wants to get in that well contest. She looks
good. I love
good.
That girl.
Did you see that, Rick? Oh, damn it. Damn it.
Bring her in and tell her
you missed
to
it.
Show Anthony so he can see how she would do in the contest.
Grab Swiss Miss.
You're a pal there, Ronnie.
Yeah. I'm trying to do anything to get over the blind Olympics. Not everybody gets a medal here, big man.
Here comes
wow.
Swiss.
Wow. What is
this? Schoolgirl outfit.
They're in schoolgirl uniform.
Nurse Myron
no
Swiss Miss.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. And the skirt comes off.
And they're falling all over each other. How great
you know,
is that?
Oh, my God.
Are the skirts even necessary? I mean, really.
Oh, they're all over each other.
All right. You guys do your song while the girls make out in the corner.
All right. Here's Carter. Fender Music Jeff, once again, on Ron and Fez.
Count off, 1, 2, 3, 4. With karate, I'll kick your ass. Here to the Tiananmen Square. Oh, yeah, mother effer. I'm gonna... Yeah, yeah. You broke all the rules. And I'll pull out your care. Your mother lover. Your mother lover. Kyle betrayed me and I tried to hide and I died deep inside. And you know the reason why. I'm gonna kick your ass from here to right over there. Oh yeah, mother. On a dairy. Yeah, yeah. Broke the rules. I'm gonna pull out your hair. Your mother effer. Mother purr. Thank you.
Yeah. Short and sweet.
A lot of curses in that song.
I feel like we're finishing the marathon, but it's already dark. Most of the people have
right.
went home.
Now it's just for our own personal sake.
Right.
Our personal
line, crapping yourself. You
yeah.
know those people that
yeah.
they can't even walk.
Ron, you know, 18 hours earlier, a Kenyan walked away with a trophy. We're just doing this to prove to ourselves we can do it.
I'm going
to
say that I slowed down to be friends with the blind guy who doesn't know a song that any other human being knows. Rick, come on.
Where'd you go blind, Nam? What songs do you know?
Yeah. Oh, I'm back. Here we are.
Yeah,
yeah you're back.
That's right. Okay, now the mic is back.
Yeah. What happened to Martian? She left?
Can we go out on a good note? Let's yeah. go out on a good note.
Yeah, we want to go out, on,
go
a good
out
note,
on a good note,
Rick. Yeah, thank for the last time we've ever met you, we want to go out on a good note.
Martian is gone?
No.
We've been doing well before.
Yeah.
Yeah. She seems like she left the building.
Was she upset? Martian has left the building.
Her looking at the girls making out was yeah. like that scene in Carrie in the locker room.
I know.
Remember that?
Yeah.
It's like all the hot girls are yeah. there, and they're just throwing tampons
right.
at Martian.
Why couldn't you guys been nicer to Martian? Seriously. That was awful.
Nobody wanted to make out with Martian. None of the girls.
Yeah. We're sorry about that.
Yeah. awful.
It's,
come on. Yeah. It would have taken 2 minutes.
That's all we have to say about that.
You should have heard the talk out
I'm
there.
I'm going to go back
oh my
to feeling
God.
Some bootay.
When Ronnie said that one girl is going to make out, I ran out of the studio.
Oh, is that right? You're
yeah.
all talking
is that
about
the little gossipy catty talk yeah. in the green room?
Yeah.
Yeah. Look at the pile of girls. Wait a minute. Isn't that one girl's Mikey D?
That's the ugliest woman I've ever seen.
He's got one foot on the brake and one on the gas.
You
hey!
Want, man, I'm having fun.
Yeah, come out singing some. Let's do Mikey D singing the lead on "I Can't Drive."
Come
55.
On,
come on. Let's get the Red Rocker back into it.
Ronnie, I love his marriage.
Yeah, it works.
Come on, everybody's got.
What are you doing?
Girl, you really got me going. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing. Nobody again, right?
Girl, you really got me going. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing.
Dr. A.
Oh, yeah, you really got me. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, yeah, you really got me.
me going. You got me so I don't know what I'm doing. You really got me.
Richard Nixon has been indicted for Watergate. Stay tuned for details. Judge Sirica is going through the evidence.
What? If the Diamond David Lee Roth Sammy Hagar tour isn't coming to your town,
I think that
we just
out
brought it to you, and it stinks.
I think that's going to be
it stinks.
That'll be as good as the new Who tour with John Entwistle.
That was cubic zirconia, Dave. Jesus.
You know what's really funny about this?
What?
Nothing.
You realize
not a damn thing.
No.
Seriously. Hey, I know I've been around comedy my whole life.
It ain't your career
nothing
in the crapper,
is
Trump.
Funny.
What is, Eddie's in
how
the
many
house
people, when they do this, sing all the wrong lyrics? Like, you realize nobody ever really knew the lyrics to that song because that's, they're being exposed right for the first time.
Eddie, you think because you're wearing a backstage Danzig... He's got his backstage Danzig on.
He walks
aren't
in. He's got
cool
his backstage pass yeah from Danzig.
And acted like he was trying to peel it off, but it wouldn't quite leave his
right
shirt.
So, right,
so everyone would stop and look at what he was doing.
I got all my other passes.
Hey, if this was 1986, I'd be going, what's he like? What's he like?
I got all my other passes, too. I'm going to rotate them and wear a different one every night. No, I actually just intro dance you just played seconds yeah ago. Yeah.
I hear Eddie Trunk's about 7 feet tall and 900 pounds.
Mother!
Is that true?
Tell your children not to walk my way.
There you go.
Tell your children not to hear my word.
And then that other song. Yeah. Mother!
Yeah. Rory, open that door and scream Fez needs another beer.
Right.
Another beer! There we go, Danny did it.
It is funny, though, going to see somebody like Danzig because I'm standing there watching, and you know, the crowd's into it, and then all of a sudden the opening chords of Mother and the whole place is like, yeah! That's what I paid my $15.50 for, you know, that one song.
$15.50, it's even 1986 prices.
It is there.
Slam that thing, Fez.
Yeah.
Tell me.
Hit it hard, Fez.
And Monday, you start it all right over again, right?
Oh, yeah. Thank you, said the blind anchor.
Oh, no, that wasn't me.
Wait a minute. You know, now that doesn't matter anymore, the girls are making out in the corner
now
over
how
here.
Come I don't get
oh
to see that?
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Why don't I get to see that?
Oh, jeez.
You're blind.
Moan hard for... Hey, give her a sweet Melissa moan for Rick, the blind guy.
Oh, I love blind guys. Ooh. Can I lick your eyeball?
Oh,
it's so hot. Oh, okay. Oh, it tastes so good. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. All right. Oh, I love blind guys. Oh, it's so hot.
Give it to him, baby.
Oh, it's so... I'm gonna finish on your eyes.
Oh, yeah. Let me just zip up here, zip back up.
Ron, I'm going to take my own sight.
Out of the nightmare that tonight has been,
everybody,
all I remember, all I will remember is, can I lick your eyeballs?
That's the
sure
one.
Lick your eyeball.
And I'm going to finish
line
in your eye.
Line of the night.
What about that? I'm going to finish in your eye.
Right.
That's finish on your one non-functional eye.
And there's like there's enough room for all of us to finish in that thing.
Yep.
Seriously, Rick, it was a great time having you here tonight.
Thanks, everybody. So we're not going out with a song that's out. Hmm?
You don't know any songs that humans know.
We had so much fun.
Not even blind humans.
Oh. We would love to go out with a sing-along.
How about we
but the Kinks
out
are not a sing-along.
Well,
you're going to sound like Ray Davies to pull that off.
Yeah, Eddie's right. Nobody knows any words to all the songs. Let's have a song everybody knows the words to, right? What can we do?
Row,
row, row your boat.
Oh, jeez.
I don't know any songs.
Can't we go out with something nice?
I feel like a blind man is driving this home.
Oh. How about we go out with Johnny B. Goode? Everybody comes in.
Oh, my God.
Go.
How about that?
Okay.
One from this half of the century.
Come on, it's
the same enchantment under the sea.
Upon the evergreens, all every little love in the earth and wood. And down came a boy named Johnny B. Goode. He never ever learned a riddle right so well, but he was playing it all like a real novel.
Look, his hand is fading away.
Go, Johnny, go.
Quick, kiss her.
His hand's fading.
Kiss her.
Go, go.
There you go, man.
Go, Johnny, go, go, go. Go, Johnny, go, go!
good.
Let's do it again. Why not, right? Come on the chorus.
Go. Go, Johnny, go.
No,
go.
There's another verse.
Go, Johnny, go. Go.
We'll do the other verse.
Go, Johnny, go. Go. Go, Johnny, go. Go. Johnny, be good.
Seriously, all of you go. Go. Just go.
You will be a man, and you will be the leader of a big old band.
Oh, God.
Many people coming from miles around.
His sight's better than his musical selection.
When the sun go down. Maybe someday your name will be in lights. Sing Johnny Be Good.
Yeah,
tonight.
Baby. I said go.
No, no, we're not going
wow.
anywhere. We're not, we're not going to drop their mic. Hey,
it's off.
All right. That's it.
Yeah. I can't believe it.
We'll be back tomorrow. Monday.
Yes.
Yes.
Saturday show.
I can't believe... I never thought we would see this point in the week.
Yeah.
But this is exactly how I imagined
right.
it. This hellish nightmare.
What I'm afraid of is that you and I were actually sitting alone. And we're just...
And this
these are
all
the
visions. Happened.
I didn't see any point in this movie.
All right, yeah. We'll be back.
You're not doing this again.
Yes.
Yes. It's not
Did
over
they
yet.
They tell you you're doing this
yes.
again.
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Thank you, everyone, for coming in. Travis Bickle, happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Telling Helen happy,
happy
birthday.
Happy birthday.
Your mic's off.
I know. That's just
the blind guy yelling at?
I figured I'd yell it.
Right.
The Ron and Fez Show.